All right, everybody, welcome to another draft breakdown, this time not for the FDL, but for the ENCDL, Eastern North Carolina. I'm here joined with my wonderful co-host, Sigtrick.
Hello, hello. Glad to join you. Glad to banter about some Pokemon.
Indeed. This is another 16 team league, very similar tier list to the last one. So if you watched my last video, you will know basically a lot of these similar kind of picks. But let's just get right into it with the Darkrai Knights, coached by J-Star. So first thing I noticed, I mean, Flutterman, first overall pick, not that surprising. It's the best Pokemon in VGC right now. It's Flutterman.
Hits hard, hits fast. I mean, not much to say about it, except it's effective at what it does. You have, I guess, the option of shutting down Trick Room with Imprison. That's always on the table for him, considering the fact his team is relatively fast, with a few exceptions.
It also gets Icy Wind for the other speed control.
True. You kind of get the best of both worlds there.
And it gets Parish Song, so you can...
I don't think we'll see that this season, but
I do not.
Yes.
I don't either, but it'd be very funny. It can be used as a way to guarantee closeout games, but I would not bet on it. But the other notable strategies, Beat Up plus either Terrakion or Annihilate. With Terrakion having Justified, get to that +4 attack immediately. And with Annihilate, you can power up the Rage Fist. And it just it gets to 250 base power immediately, which is insane.
That's correct.
Then he's got the Priority Tailwind, and a couple... And he's got the Regigigas Weezing combo as well, which is funny. I think it's a lot
worse.
It's a Gen
8 thing, right? Like, I don't, because you don't have the Gigantamax for the longevity or the speed control that you get off like the Terra or Max normal moves. But this it's still funny, and I definitely think at least in draft format, like this is the better of the two Weezings to have, because you have the option of doing that, or you at the very least you have some kind of level of terrain control, or if you want like anti-sleep, like you have it, right?
Indeed. Yeah, I really like the Weezing with Misty Surge. It opens a lot of possibilities. Also with Misty Seed, if you just want to like give your like partner a boost, it can work like that too.
Misty Seed is Brez, is that right?
It gives it a special defense boost. Yeah, whenever you are on the field.
Yeah, I definitely use a Fire Emblem term there, but yes, special defense.
And then otherwise, I think it's got some generally solid mons from the Galvantula and Muk, at least Alolan Muk specifically. I think those are two like really good value D tiers. I'm a fan of this team, I gotta say. I think it's very, very good. I don't like the untiers. I think that they look a little singles pilled for me.
I mean, you get into Untier, you're kind of digging around. I have seen like a Cybertron video where he covered like a Toxapex style team, which was interesting, but I don't think he has the pieces for that here.
Little
fun. So I mean, full transparency is he was working, so I had to draft for him. So we went over what the things he wanted me to get, and his was so much easier to draft for than my own team. I'll say that much. But the one thing I think I messed up on is I think in order of things that he wanted, there was the Medicham pick that he wanted before the Muk. So there potentially should have been a Medicham here that got picked that same round, which of course would have had has Fake Out. I know it has the skill swap with the Pure Power. I don't remember if it has Follow Me. I don't think it does. But,
it does not.
Definitely a good value mon for it was, but yeah. And then the Typhlosion's kind of sitting here. I mean, it works. You have the Icy Wind speed control like we mentioned earlier, so you could still get off some big eruptions.
Something I do really like about Hisuian Typhlosion over regular is that it has Frisk, which in normal VGC is bad. It's just a useless ability because of open team sheets. But in draft, you don't get that information. So being able to get that little bit extra information over your opponent, I think, is really nice and a little underrated. Also, the ghost typing means it can't be faked out, which is the biggest...
I was about to add that on there. Yep.
Biggest problem with regular Typhlosion.
Don't stop my eruption. Yeah, and the other thing is... The Walking Wake team actually drafted regular Typhlosion over the Hisuian Typhlosion. I think that was just a preference, I like this one better kind of thing. Mm-hmm. But I definitely think this is the better Typhlosion to pick up for sure.
Yeah, the other one is better in singles. This one's better in doubles, I would say. But yeah, other things of note is that especially going back to Alolan Muk, I think that's one of the best value pick on this entire team, other than maybe Fluttermane. But you know, it's an S tier. Alolan Muk has historically been incredible in lower powered formats, which draft is. In VGC 2017, I believe, it was the first Sun and Moon year, whereas the regional decks for Sun and Moon, Alolan Muk was a powerhouse, a top five mon for sure.
Oh, really?
it was. It's Poison Dark is one of the best defensive typings in the game.
Weak to only ground.
Only weak to ground. And Alolan Muk was very bulky, and what's it called? What's the poison move that can miss? Gunk shot was incredible in that gen or that game because there were so many good fairy types. So
I've heard some recent complaints about this mon actually in the current format. He doesn't have the pieces for it here. That was the one thing that got sniped from him, other than the Medicham, was this. He did want Smeargle, and that got picked up pretty early. But the thing I've heard about is the minimize Alolan Muk, and then it has Power of Alchemy. So then I think when Smeargle dies, it gets like the Moody Boosts or something like that. It's supposed to be pretty dirty, but we're not going to see that here. But interesting nonetheless.
Yeah, it's a gimmick, but it's like I've said this before. The difference between a gimmick and a legitimate strategy is whether or not it works.
Fair enough.
And if it works, it'll work. It's good. If you can get it off. But yeah, I mean, just really awesome defenses with 105 HP, 75 defense, and 100 special defense. For a D tier, that's incredible. And it also kind of helps with his like Trick Room, which we said it was like, pretty good into the team. Because it's one of his few taunters, actually. And
okay. I feel like, I mean, I don't know off the top of my head, but I feel like Does like Mousehold and like Terrakion not get taunt? I feel like they do. I know Talonflame does.
I think Terrakion does. Talonflame and Terrakion do. The problem is the opportunity cost. Terrakion is a nice taunter, but with Talonflame, you kind of want to be like doing other things. And if you're playing as Trick, you probably didn't want to bring Talonflame in the first place, I would say.
That's fair. Okay. You got me.
But you're right. There are other taunters, but I think
Weezing can do it too, doesn't he?
Wait, can it? There's a lot of weird Pokemon that can.
That's funny. Like I've seen Taunt Weezing back in Gen 8, but I don't know. I could be talking out. I could pull up Picolytics right here.
I also really like aesthetically, I like the combo of Muk and Weezing in their alternate forms. I think that's really fun.
That's true. It's true. Yeah, it does get Taunt.
Okay, nice.
That's actually one of those pickups I didn't expect him to be able to get, because he mentioned he wanted this combo, but somebody picked up Weezing early in the draft, the Cantonian one, and then they came back to their next pick, and I was like, I know what you're going to pick, and he didn't pick it, and I was like, well, you know, I hate to do it to you, but it's on the list of things I'm supposed to do, and I took the Weezing and the Gigas for J-Star, so.
Yep. All right, I think...
I don't know what the guy was planning, but yep.
I don't have much else to say on this one. I fear that Cloyster could be bait, and he might be trapped into thinking it's good. But with Mousehold, you know, it has Follow Me, so you can do like, something with it, but it's I'm scared that if he gets sucked into thinking it's it'll work one week and then it doesn't.
He's definitely a VGC player, and you can tell that by some of the compositions he's got here. So like I don't think he expects it to work unless he knows something that I don't, so I guess we'll just stay tuned. He probably just quickly looked at untiered and was like, let me find something, but don't know.
It also kind of looks like he just wanted a water type, and then he's like, all right, well, neither of these are good, so I'll pick up both and hopefully they'll
Gyarados was like a backup pick for him, and that went pretty relatively early, so that was the one water type. So
all right, next up, we got the Rocky Mount Meowstics.
Yes, with the immediate... wow, I have this sheet's wrong. I just realized the Raging Bolt and the Ninetales are backwards. But regardless, the immediate A-tier pick for the Ninetales... I'm setting up Snow, is what he said. Anybody who was looking to get a good S-tier pick, we're definitely welcomed him doing that early on. But, the power of Ninetales, immediately having double screens, with a, I think, base 109 speed, if I'm correct. You know, a powerful start. And of course, you see that he picked up the Bax Caliber later on down the list. So definitely good support for that.
Yep. Yeah, that's, it makes a very, very devastating combo there, where basically you have to get rid of the Ninetales before it can set up the screens. Otherwise, Caliber just becomes unkillable physically. It gets the Snow Boost and the Aurora Veil Boost.
Mm-hmm.
Which it sets up one Dragon Dance, and you are just out of luck. But yeah, I also like that he has two good fairy types, because fairy types are kind of hard to come by in this draft. Good fairy types, at least. And being able to get Enamorous and Alolan Ninetales is really nice, because it also means that other teams don't have those good fairy types for your two tier dragon types, you know?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. The look, I mean, looking at his team, he's got like a lot of like, I want to say like trick room esh looking things in here, but at the same time, he doesn't have like the fastest Tailwinders either. Assuming both of those birds, Decidueye and Braviary, can learn Tailwind.
Yes, they can.
So I don't know. Speed control might be an issue for this team. I don't want to say it is for sure, but okay.
Honestly, I think his best form of speed control is Icy Wind from Ninetales or Frostlass, which is not good. I mean, that's fine.
Yeah.
But it's not, if that's your
it's okay.
Best
it,
form,
it depends on, it depends week to week, right? Because if you have somebody who's just faster than Ninetales, then that could be a problem.
Mm-hmm.
And obviously, people are going to be trying to shut down Ninetales.
Frostlass is 110, but yes.
Yeah, you're not, yeah. All right. Got him by a point there. But yeah.
Yeah. If you're one point faster, then you're, it's a 1 point difference, you know. But I also, it looks like they're really going for, like, threatening a
on ice.
Real trick room mode, and also all the ice moves.
There's a lot of fire weaknesses here, but
yeah.
Granted, you have thermal exchange, but
yeah, I don't think he has a single. Yeah, there's one fire resist, and then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 fire weaknesses. So I don't know if I don't love that. I also don't love the trick room mode on here. It's like he has a pretty good time setting it up because Slowking, if like Oblivious or it can make sure, basically guarantee it goes up. But he doesn't really have a lot of great ways to abuse it. Because his trick, like he has Enamorous, which is good, but it's not the slowest mon. So if you go up against something like it's actually a really hard trick room mon, then it's like, okay, well, I can't actually do that very well. An Earthworm and Mammoth Swine, I think that was a pair there, just to be able to press Earthquake next to it. But Mammoth Swine's not really that slow. You wouldn't really want to use it outside of Trick Room. You wouldn't want to use Earthworm or Enamorous outside of Trick Room. I don't know. I don't love this team, but I do like a lot of the parts individually, so I think it could do well.
Yeah. Again, the speed controls is weird. And I don't know how they're going to want to play it out. I mean, you can clearly, like, Bax Caliber itself can, like, either Scale Shot or it can, but, or Dragon Dance, I guess. But outside of that, like, yeah, it's going to be interesting to see where the speed comes from on this team, whether they're really relying on that Icy Wind or if they're going to try to do some more Trick Room shenanigans. And then, yeah, I don't know how consistent that'll be.
Mm-hmm. Yep. All right. Yeah, do you have any other thoughts on any of the Pokemon? I know you like Slowking,
I like Slowking. I've used Slowbro in the past as a Trick Room setter for a past VGC team, so I do stand by that pick. And it, of course, it being the Slowking, it has the ability to Chilly Reception, so he gives him a second way of setting up Snow. Mm-hmm. So I mean, there is that. I do respect that pick, and then. I guess the only thing that we didn't really talk about is there is the Thwacky for the cheap grassy terrain. I don't know where that's going to come into play. Maybe he just wants to have something for terrain control because he has the weather. So I don't know. We will see.
It's just a solid. It's a pretty solid untiered mon. It's Rillaboom at home, but when Rillaboom's in S tier, it's like you're at home.
It's
still pretty good.
It's still terrain with Fake Out, right? Mm-hmm. So.
And his attack isn't the worst thing ever, so you can get off some relatively good damage, grassy glides. Yeah. All right. Oh, next up is me. We got my team, with the Appalachian Aggrons. I think my team.
How do you want to approach this? Do you want to start off by bragging, or do you want me to like try to like dissect this, and you can tell me where I'm wrong? Like, how do you want to go about this?
I mean, I was just mostly. I just want to start with the fact that. The Brock EX let me get Incineroar. Thank you very much. You're a real one for that. Your check is in the mail. I started off with the Fire Water Grass core. I was just thinking, yeah, this is really good defensive big pairing. All three of these are just really good Pokemon. And I don't know, I think the team's pretty solid.
I think a common lead for you is going to be leading Palafin and then switching it out for the Incineroar just to get the Intimidate on switch in and getting the Palafin, you know, into his zero to hero mode. You can tell me if I'm wrong about that. What is the Sinistee doing? You got redirection, you have some healing. And then you have Trick Room options. I don't know. I guess you could run Trick Room. I mean, obviously you have Swift Swim and you have Sand Rush. So, I mean, you have all kinds of different ways you can like you can do speed control here. You're going to be a hard player to predict the way your team is kind of laid out here.
Yes.
I know at one point you were telling me you were kind of contemplating doing the Parachon shenanigans and then the Gothitelle went away, which I think honestly was a blessing in disguise because I think Parish trapping, especially in draft format, is going to be really, really hard to do. But you have the Glamora there, and what's the strat with the Glamora? I know that's one of your at least you used it in single, so I assume it's one of your favorite mons from Gen 9. What is your game plan with it going into this team?
So I just kind of wanted a poison type because I didn't really have a way to hit fairy types other than 85% accurate gunk shot. And Skarmory is not real. Skarmory is a fighting type Pokemon. I fear, but I just want another way to hit fairies, and I also wanted a rock type to benefit from sand to make the sand mode a little bit better. Because as a two Pokemon pair, the sand mode was kind of felt a little bit lacking. And I mean, Last Respect is great, and if I wanted to do like support, that's also like pretty solid with Houndstone, obviously. With it can do like Snarl, Will-O-Wisp.
Snarl.
It does.
Oh,
it,
the Houndstone. Can... The Houndstone. Oh, okay. Yeah, okay. Yeah. Sorry. I thought you were talking about the Glamora. I was like, what?
Oh, no, no. And then I was thinking I kind of wanted another way to like just use the sand well. And I didn't have a rock type already. And it's like, Glamora, it's one I've used before. I'm comfortable with it. I like it. And it's also actually the strongest mon on my team. Like, it has the highest attack stat out of any.
All right, well.
Palafin.
You're not fooling me with the Palafin there, my friend.
Yeah, okay, but at first, Palafin baby form is only like 75
attack.
Yeah,
yeah, yeah.
So.
That's going to be an intimidating Incineroar on turn one. I already know. So.
Right.
Then he's going to parting shot, and then the fish is going to be right back where he was. So.
Yes, I had something else I liked about this team. It has a lot of ways to pivot in and out with... I'm not as sold on the sand mode as I would like to be. That's why the reason I picked Glamma.
I think sand is very strange without Excadrill, but the I think like you said, Last Respects can certainly hit hard. It's mm-hmm. just Last Respects is not as carried away in doubles as it is in singles, I suppose.
You only get up to you only get up to 150 or 200 base power.
Which to be fair, I don't know what Houndstone's attack is, but the
it's like in the high 90s, I believe.
101. So not bad.
Yeah.
Not bad. So you have an Intimidate Mon with Quillfish, I believe, but you're probably gonna be using Swift Swim most of the time.
I don't know.
No?
I would like to
depends
I think
on what squad you bring, right?
Mm-hmm. Having a variety makes it really like makes it a lot even that much better.
And then I know you were saying earlier fairies were hard to come by. I see the Alcremie. I know there's also like decorate on Alcremie. Like is Alcremie like realistically? Like what's your realistic plans with Alcremie?
I thought it got Moonblast and it doesn't. So that could be really that's what it was. Now it does kill Luring Voice now, so it's an 80 power, like single target move. Before it had to rely on Dazzling Gleam, it just the damage output was just not there. It's mostly just because I caught a shiny one in game and I wanted to rep it.
First off, you brought up Luring Voice, which I think is a really cool move they added. They gave it to Eevee, which is really cool, because that's one of the problems with the Eeveelutions is a lot of them are lacking, like, the move pool depth. So, like, I really like that move. And on a personal note, if you have a particular Alcremie flavor that you'd like to be on your page, then tell me after this conversation, and I can certainly adjust that for you.
Can we get the can we get a shiny blueberry one?
Absolutely.
Awesome. All right. We're keeping this in the video. And then also notably, I went and watched the VOD of the draft, and I saw that you guys didn't know what Riolu does. You figured it out, but it was Prankster Coaching, but it was later. Also, it sets weather. It's a secondary weather setter.
Okay. Well, I know, and it can also, can't it like disrupt Trick Room? Because like the way it does like the copycat.
Yes.
It's like it keeps the priority, so you like immediately you can reverse it, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yes.
So that's a good thing. So yeah, I know it's
got. It only works if they don't have it. It's no psychic terrain, though. It doesn't work. It also, because it's priority. So if it, I don't know. Does it need? I don't remember. I have to go back and check my mechanics.
Because I know it depends on the prankster move, right? So like taunt targets, but does copycat target? Right.
I don't. Maybe it doesn't because you just copies the last move used. If it doesn't matter who used
I don't think. I don't think it would. But that's a good question for like Weaselman's team, right?
Yeah.
So, something for you to look up.
Mm-hmm. I mostly wanted Sinistra over some of the other like solid grass types because of its bulk. It just has really solid all around bulk, and I don't actually care that much about. And more importantly, again, is the heat proof. Although it's not
so
as big of a deal on rain, but if I didn't get rain.
Round three was probably the biggest heartbreaking round for me, and you were part of that shenanigan, and I can talk about that more when we get to my team. But the Sinista was part of the three Mons that disappeared in one round that were on my list. So
I see. Yeah, I mean, I Machi Gacha is a crazy move. It's also one of the Mons that got Scald back.
Oh, I didn't know what it's called. That's interesting.
It does. Yeah. And hospitality is really a unique ability. I hope to be able to use it well with all the pivoting I can do in and out with Incineroar and flip turn on my water mons.
I'll say as somebody who has the Clangor's Soul option, I would have appreciated the top off and the redirection. But that's a conversation for later.
Yep. I don't think I have anything else to say on my team.
Looks solid. It looks like I said, it's gonna be hard to predict what you're going to bring. Yeah. So I think that's a good making of a draft team. So interested to see your matches for sure.
All right. Next up, we got Tekka with the Winterville Weavile. Third Sun team. I think there's two Sun teams in this draft.
This is the first one in my mind because we were telling him, teaching him some basic VGC stuff in the call, and he's like, at the end of the call, he's like, you know, I kind of want to run Sun. So I shot myself in the foot because that's something I was thinking about, and I was like, well, you know, you're the fourth round pick, you should pick the one water type that works in Sun.
Mm-hmm.
And so, as we see, his first pick was Walking Wake, as it should have been. Obviously, a great Mon in either Rain or Sun, but. Yep.
It's also why it's the best Sunmon, because most of the time you use Rain Dance and get rid of the Sun and also hurt the fire moves, and it's like, oh, Hydra's team, it's still the same damage.
Exactly. So, yeah, just absolutely should have been his first pick, and it was, so right on the money there.
Yep, and then we got the...
He did lose out on Torkoal. That was picked on the way back up in round two before it got back to him. So he grabbed the Ninetales as his backup Sunny Day option. Of course, you know, there was the other option would have been like I guess he has Murkrow. He has Murkrow as well. Yep. So he's got two backup Sunny Day options. In Prankster, Sunny Day, and Ninetales. There's his son. We mentioned the Typhlosion earlier. That's his favorite start of all time. And probably gonna be paired little bit better with Murkrow than Ninetales just to get the tailwind up and then the sunny day boost. A funny pick that I overheard, or a funny combo, I should say, is he, and I think there was a late game pickup for him. I think both his A tiers were pretty late for him, as a matter of fact. But the Sandy Shocks has, I think, one... I'm trying to remember the combo. I think it has one speed. Yeah, it's 1 point faster than Ninetales, I think. I think it's 101 and Ninetales is like 100. And so like the funny combo is that you get the boost.
Oh, from, you gravity. The gravity hypnosis.
Gravity hypnosis. Yeah.
Yeah, usually used with a Smathra because the Smathra gets speed boost. And so at first, Sandy Shocks is faster, and then on the second turn, Smathra is faster. So you get the second thing put to sleep. But yeah, I mean, any Hypnosis user can work with it.
Yep.
As long as they're slower.
We also see the Lilligant, which I think is more of like a Torkoal pairing because of like the After You shenanigans, but Lilligant's still a good option because it has a
I fear you have miscalculated on this one. This is a setup sweeper. It doesn't need stun. This gets victory dance. I mean, therefore, it is
Sure. Well, I mean, I guess the only problem with that, does he have any redirection on this team for setup?
No. He has ally switch with Oranguru.
That's true. That's certainly an annoying option that someone could do. She has ice spinner, so she has a little terrain removal as well, and that's a good... Because she doesn't have the deepest move pool, but having ice is always a nice coverage option, right?
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Skull Villain, I know it gets like a weird move that like drops your defense and boosts your special, or no, your physical, what is it? Remind me. But
yeah, so it drops, or it raises attack by 2 stages and drops defense by 2 stages on any Pokemon.
So you could use that either to weaken your opponent and then knock them out, or you could boost yourself to knock them out. Like, you have two ways of going about that, I suppose.
Historically, it was used with Dragapult, Mirror Herb, where Dragapult would copy the attack boost. Because of Clear Body, it would not get the defense boost, or defense drop. So you use really it on your opponent, and you would just guarantee a one-hit KO.
I mean, depending on where you are on the match with Dragon Darts, you can knock out two Pokemon. That's certainly interesting.
Yep. Can't do that.
That would have been another S tier pick. So yeah, exactly.
Yeah, I think more importantly, it's a Chlorophyllmon that can also benefit, like, get the power boost from the sun. Which is I think it's the only one that actually does that outside of like using like Weather Ball, and then you don't get the stab boost. So I think it's neat. The unfortunate part is that it's still not that fast, even with Chlorophyll.
I mean, it's a D tier pick, right? So, I mean, he probably got one of the better things he could for his team but I mean, it's definitely going to be a little gimmicky at best, but it could do some funny things.
Yeah. I don't like that it added another flying weakness, but, I mean, you're running a bunch of grass types for Chlorophyll. It's going to happen.
Yeah, I mean, he's only got two grass types here.
Two grass types, but then also a bug type and a fighting type. He's got four flying weaknesses, and he's got two resists, but only one way to hit it back with Sandy Shocks. So I'd be very wary of that, I guess I will say.
Fair enough. But the bug coverage could be kind of, and great. Granted, you base his week to week on your opponent. Bug coverage is usually not super high, but. Mm-hmm. Yeah, we'll see. I don't know there's much to say about the untiered mons in general.
Lumineon is Storm Drain and a secondary Tailwind Setter.
Okay, so a little water redirection. That's not bad.
Always good when you have like a bunch of water weaknesses, like this team does. There's not that many, but only one resist.
And then we mentioned earlier when we were talking about J-Star, we have the Skill Swap Pure Power. He doesn't really have... Honestly, his team lacks some physical mons for the most part, outside of the big King Gambit that's staring me in the face. I don't know. That's true.
Lilligant doesn't really want to give up its Chlorophyll if it's running it, but if you're not doing Sun, then yeah, they're definitely a very good mon to get.
Yeah, it's interesting. I don't know how much we'll see it with his team. the way it's set up.
I think
but,
Medicham is likely just to be used more as a just fake out mon, and then just hit pretty hard itself.
Is that his only fake out user? Yeah, I guess it is. Mm-hmm. I think.
So, yeah.
Okay. Fair enough. And I think it also has some interesting priority things. So if he's going against like the little Ninetales, I'm pretty certain it has bullet punch,
it
right?
Does have
which
bullet
can one
punch.
Shot it. If it doesn't have the sash, that's going to definitely kill Ninetales.
Well, maybe. Boy.
That's four times weak. And Ninetales doesn't exactly have defense. I would bet on the calc, but
if it definitely will if he goes Terra Steel. I would.
That's true. He could tear. You're right about that. Oh. Now that's fair.
Yes. And then I'm upset with the Oranguru pick because he sniped it from Trey.
Oh, did Trey have instruct shenanigans that he was gonna do?
No, it's just the best trick room setter, maybe ever. If your one goal is to set trick room, Oranguru is probably the best mon to do it.
Now, why is that?
With Terra, you can go Terra Dark to stop like Prankster, or you can go Terra Ghost to stop Fake Out. It has Inner Focus or I believe Oblivious or Own Temp, but one of the ones, whatever the one that stops, it can't, means you can't be taunted.
That's Oblivious.
So it just has every it basically has a way to stop every form of like the common trick room. Like stoppers, I guess.
Yeah, it looks like so it looks like it has Inner Focus. So like the most common set's Inner Focus, Mental Herb. So that kind of covers both, mm-hmm. like you said.
And it can go, yeah. But and then Terra Grass is top Spore as well. You can do, or whatever combo. It has basically all the tools to not get faked out or to always set up Trick Room, guaranteed.
Yep.
Which I don't think is actually that good on this team, but.
No, this team's way too fast. Mm-hmm. This team's not going to intentionally set it up. Now, that's a good question. Does Oranguru have in prison? And I'm not seeing it on its list of tricks in top usage, so I'm guessing not. So, yeah, I don't know what the incentive here for that pick was.
Make sure everyone else can't set up Trick Room against. That's why.
Maybe. I think the only thing we haven't really talked about in this team is the King Gambit. I know that was like it might have been his last round pick.
It was
definitely a late
pick
for him. It's strange on a Sun team because obviously you make that steel weakness a little worse. King Gambit in his own right is a strong mon. I don't know what else it really offers here though. I guess you also have like a potential Defiant user. His team's mostly special. I don't think you bring an Intimidate mon against this team.
Yeah.
So, yeah, I think it's a very it's an odd pick. I think there were other A tiers he could have gone for. It would have fit a little better.
I still think the Grimmsnarl was, like, the perfect pick for this team, but he said he wasn't creative enough to use it. And that's understandable.
All he needs to know is screens and sunny day. Yeah. Screens and sunny day. That's all he needed. But, yeah, I agree with you. I think that would have been a solid pick.
I know I was trying to pill him on it in the call, but he went with King Gambit.
I mean, he can still be pilled. He still has five trades remaining.
That's true.
So.
That's true.
And we're still in the preseason, so like anything before Sunday is fair game for week one. So maybe that conversation needs to happen.
Mm-hmm. Are you anything else on this one?
I don't think so. I think we've talked about it a long time.
All right. Then we got the Tick Bite Joltiks. The fifth.
This could be a scary team because immediately you see the Ndidi and the Armourouge, the season one classic combo there,
mm-hmm. and the Gen 8 with that. This team is scary. Except it's scary until you realize that he can't actually run like four Trick Room mons. He only has three and Bastion on, but that's not real.
Well, like Zach is definitely a man who doesn't like picking real mons, but his first three are certainly very threatening. And as you mentioned, the Hatterene with the Ndidi, the Gen 8 power we know is very strong, though she doesn't have max, I suppose. Expanding Force hits like a truck regardless.
Yeah, and two Expanding Forcers and... I do like that a lot of the rest of the team is like made to punish like dark and ghost types. Because that's, but also he's added two more dark and ghost because I don't know. I don't love this team because I think you just put a single like dark type move on your mons and you're hitting over half the team for super effective, right?
Yeah,
you're
not over half, I mean, but half the team. Somebody could literally pick up Tyranitar from the A tier and counter this team for the most part with a Terra.
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
because obviously you have to watch out for the Gallade if you're a T-tar, but
yeah, I think it's it looks like it should have been a hard Trick Room team, and then Weasel Man just said, I actually don't want to play Trick Room anymore with the draft.
I mean, I definitely like the idea of having multiple options for draft, right? Mm-hmm. But the I would agree. It's definitely not.
I think you needed one more Trick Room abuser. Personally.
Well, I mean, out of the ones that were left over, did you have somebody like in the back of your mind that you're like, you know, you should have picked up that Mon? Like
No, because I don't like Trick Room, so I was not thinking about it at all.
Fair enough.
But I'm sure actually, yes, there is one that I would like to see over Bastiodon, a Alolan Golem.
Okay, just for explosion shenanigans, or
no? Don't even think about it. I mean, you can explode if you want, but I would not personally. It's just its stats are really bad. It's Golem stats, but Galvanized Double Edge is so funny. It's so strong.
I mean, you can galvanize, explode. I'm just saying, and then I think someone was talking about this in the call the other day, where like you galvanize, explode, and you have Rabska or whatever. I think it has like telepathy or something, and then use revival blessing. Yeah,
yeah.
But yeah, we're getting off topic now. The what do you think about the pick of Armourouge over Iron Crown for this team?
I don't like it at all, actually.
Okay.
I think that if you're planning on getting Hat and Armourouge, do the exact same thing. Fill the same role to a T. And I think Iron Crown does, it's also an expanding force user, but it's fast. Which would give you another mode that you have to prep for. Right now, if you're scared of the Psy Spam, you have to prep for Trick Room. Before, anyway, if you take Iron Crown instead, then I think it varies it quite a bit. I also like the steel typing more than the fire, personally.
So I do want to defend myself here. I've noticed another. So when we were going through and filling out these player pages with the the icons, Kane started in the front and I started from the back. This is another case of the Dragapult was the S tier pick, not the Ndidi. The Ndidi was the first pick. So he just kind of went through here and put them in order. So I'm guessing a lot of these are probably not in the spot they're supposed to be in. Because I was about to say, instead of Dragapult, he should have grabbed Iron Crown. And I was like, well, wait a minute. And then I was like, okay, never mind. Never mind.
So. I believe everything else is in the right spot, actually.
Okay. He may have just drafted it in a close to correct order, but... Yeah, we'll keep an eye on that for some of the upcoming keys. I know I corrected one prior to this call. I didn't think to go look for others.
It's funny. But... I didn't even think about it. I was like, oh yeah, Ndidi, that could be an S tier. I believe that.
It feels like an S tier, right? I mean, you get terrain, you get Trick Room, you get redirection. Like she does everything, right? She's such a good mon. And obviously it enables both Armourouge and Iron Crown. But I also agree with putting them in the same tier because you have to commit your A tier to that, right? And so, as the guy who was the, fifth pick or something like that?
Yeah.
He pretty much grabbed the NDD first, which is smart, because then you have the option of Iron Crown or Armourouge if somebody decides to try to pick up one of the other two with, like, male NDD or something. But.
Yep. I don't have too many other thoughts. I don't love I don't love its speed control. Outside of Trick Room, and whenever most of your team is kind of middling speed, you got Dragapult, which can like Thunder Wave, which is pretty nice. And then I guess Zebstrika can Bulldoze, but that's like that's so mid.
I think Zebstrika is like a counter pick mon, right? Because it has like Lightning Rod, it has Sap Sipper. I think it has a third one as well. So like I think that is strictly there for like counter picking teams. The motor drive and lightning rod. Okay, so it's two electric ones. The The big one he threw a fit about, though, when he didn't get it and immediately traded for it right after the draft, was the Bruxish pick, which is, you know, anti-priority. But, you know, Zach just loves Bruxish. So, I mean, I don't know what else to say. It's got Psychic Fangs, anti-priority. Does it do anything else that's really worth noting?
A Wave Crash, I guess. It's got decent-ish attack. I don't know. Ace
100 there. Or no, 105. So, yeah, I has Aqua Jet. Which I guess it has its it doesn't turn off its own priority. It's a Trick Room user, I guess. That's interesting, actually. So it is Trick Room that can't be faked out. But you already have Ndidi, so like that's kind of beside the point. So yeah, I'm not certain about that. But I know he loves Bruxish. I'm sure we'll see plenty of Bruxish if it's anything like Electrosh in singles, whatever the Dark Bug was. But low kicks. Yeah, we'll just see what kind of shenanigans Weasel Man gets up to.
Yep. I'm confused on this team. Overall, just my final verdict is that I am confused. But yeah, he has a lot in the right matchups. I think he could just totally sweep. So I think it's possibly
for sure. I mean, I think if somebody doesn't have an answer to Trick Room, that could be a problem for sure. Or if somebody doesn't have like a lot of dark types or something, that could be a problem. But
yeah, I fear Terra makes this team worse because you know they're going to go. Realistically, their best offense is expanding force. So you just throw a Terra Dark onto something. If you have another dark type already, you can't do that at all. And if they want to use Hat, which is the better, they could have run into dark types. It's like you have to really hope Ndidi does not die. To the double up.
Yeah.
But,
that's true.
Yeah. I like Crocodile, though. I think that's a really good pick. I think that's
it's a cheap Intimidator, right? And so, and he's decently fast. He's like, what, 92, 97, something like that?
I think in the 90s.
Wow. 92. I got it right the first time.
Okay, you got it.
But,
yeah, good Intimidator. It's got his overall pretty solid stats and has decent coverage with like, Gunk Shot, I know. It might get the Fangs, like the Elemental Fangs.
Well, it did get knockoff recently, so that's nice. Obviously, you know, you could do like a Scarf Rock Slide set, but again, that assumes you're not doing Trick Room. Scorching Sands is like, I think, a Ground Scald. So it's got some stuff. It's got some stuff. Taunt. Taunt's, I guess, a good one to bring up.
I wish he had I guess also he can do Ndidi and Poltergeist and redirect instead of Shell Smash, I think that's a much better Shell Smasher than Cloyster like we've seen before in VGC.
I think in the case of both, unless the player is like showing that they're doing it very common all season, you're not gonna like use Mirror Herb as like an item on one of your mons unless it's really just something you 100% expect them to do.
Yeah.
So, like, you can get away with it a little bit here, but, yeah, possible.
Yep. All right. Next up, we got Charlottezards.
Okay.
It's the double genie picks.
Somehow, he was the last person to pick up an S tier, and somehow Tornadus Incarnate was left on the table. And first off, I should have picked that mine up. Like, I told myself I was going to pick it up, and I didn't do it. But yeah, there's just no reason not to pick that mine up. Like, it does everything. You have control, you have weather, taunt. Mm-hmm. It now is enough. It's like the only, I don't want to say only, but it's like the prankster mon because it has an offensive presence. Like, that's the problem with a lot of prankster support mons is like, okay, they're going to support. You ignore them and just do the one-on-one and deal with it. But this thing has like essentially a hydro pump that hits both opponents and can drop their speed.
Well, it's a hurricane.
Well, I say hydro pump because it's 80% accuracy.
Oh, right.
And it's like 100 power, which I guess hydro pump's 110. But yeah, I mean, you're right. It is a flying move. I should specify that. But
and also, it always hits in rain. That's why I called it a hurricane.
Well, and it's interesting because he's got both genies here. So if he sets up rain, they both get 100% accuracy on their their new moves. So definitely, Definitely could be going for some range shenanigans, but I mean, outside of that, doesn't not a lot of this screams rain team aside, like maybe pre-marina, but even then you're just getting the extra stab.
I don't see a lot of like big combos on this team. I just see a lot of like solid, except for the Tornadus and Bramblegast with Windrider, but everything else is kind of like solid mods. I think it's good.
I don't disagree with that strategy in draft. Like being unpredictable and being flexible, I think are definitely higher valued than having what you mentioned earlier is the word gimmicks. Because if they don't work, they're gimmicks. But yes. The one I'm questioning right now is he took Clefairy from me, which I left on the table long enough because I wasn't certain if I wanted to like not get power from the A tier as opposed to getting the support from Clefairy. But like what's his setup mon here? Like he has Haxorus who has Dragon Dance.
Scrafty has Dragon Dance.
Well, I don't think we're going to be seeing Dragon Dance Scrafty. I'm just trying to think like what was he trying to do with Clefairy
Nasty
on this team?
Plot,
right?
Lucario. I don't know. I'm really not sure. Maybe just. Keep Landorus incarnate alive longer, I guess.
There's Life Dew and Friend Guards. I mean, that's always there. Mm-hmm. But yeah, I don't know. I mean, maybe he'll show me what he's trying to do there. But he did say it before he took it. He's like, it's like, you know, hey, Sig, you're gonna want this, aren't you? I'm like, I mean, probably. And he's like, yeah, well, you're not gonna have it. Like that's essentially what it boiled down to. Which, hey, you know, whatever. He's got two fairy types, as you mentioned earlier. Fairy types are kind of hard to come by. He's got two of the better ones, I'd say.
Yep.
Does Iron Moth have setup moves? I know it doesn't get Quiver Dance. I would hope.
I think it's Fiery Dance, but that's also an attack.
Right.
I don't think it gets any
setup. I think I would have known. With it having higher speed and higher special attack, there's no way it has it. Yeah, it doesn't. So this is a widespread move mon, right? You got Sledge Wave and Heat Wave, though I don't think he has any.
It's
Lucario. Yeah. Lucario, I think when he picked it up, that was like the last e-speed mon, so that's probably the real draw there, but
yep. If I had gotten Chien Pao, which I wouldn't have because
you had it in
third place.
And
I think Chien Pao is the fourth like S tier that I wanted. So it's like I would never take it.
Yeah. Nope. Yep.
but that was and Lucario was definitely a mon that I was looking at for that because like the other extreme speeders were all like A tier and this one was like, down here in D with the same base attack. It's like, oh yeah. Right, might as well. Yeah, same base attack as Entei.
Yeah. So a couple of interesting things here. He's got the budget Ursaluna. In Ursa Ring, which I guess you just throw an Eviolite on it and just be a weaker version of that.
It has fully evolved stats that you can pair with an Eviolite. I think that's just basically the entire idea behind it.
Does it still have Scrappy? Or I don't know what Ursa Ring has, but I don't know. Maybe we're just diving too much into that one because it was like a later pick for him. So just kind of. The other one, which you mentioned earlier, is the Weezing, which he didn't immediately get the Gigas. So it makes me wonder, did he have another plan for Weezing? So, like, obviously it's the neutralizing gas, because Levitate's kind of like, whatever here. But, what are you turning off, right?
I mean, you're not turning off anything.
Unless it's a counterpick.
Yeah, so usually the way that you could use it even without Regigigas, or use Weezing, is that if you have a bunch of mons that don't, like, if their ability isn't unnecessary, it's like all the Quark Drive and like Protosynthesis. If you switch it in after they use the booster energy, you keep the booster boost. You already didn't have an ability anyways, basically. But a lot of the other mons on this team really like their ability. Like Tornadus and Landorus really need it. Clef kind of needs it a lot. Like its Friend Guard's really good. Pre-Marina is. It's basically what makes them on viable.
Well, and if you have Clefairy and Weezing on the field at the same time, I don't know what you're doing.
Yeah, I mean, that's true. But, he has Iron Moth, and that's a good pair. They're both poison types, so I don't know if you really want to bring them both. You want your Intimidate to go off. So maybe you get the Intimidate, you switch Weezing in, then you switch it back out. That's a lot of nothing on the field.
I really think it had to have been the Gigas, and he just got overconfident that nobody was going to pick up Gigas at that point. But, I mean, if that was your plan... then why not get the Gigas first? Because there's two Weezings, right?
Yeah. I don't know.
I'm looking at his draft order now. I'm trying to see where did all this happen at? Because Weezing was his third round pick. He picked Weezing third out of everything. Like that blows my mind. And then he immediately picked up Iron Moth after that. So like,
yeah.
I don't know what was being cooked here in this particular moment in time.
Yeah, I have no idea.
Maybe we'll find out.
I think this is a pretty good draft. That's what I will say.
He's got Palpamon. Like he's got Redirection. I don't. Yeah. Yeah. The Gothita's strange because wasn't the other Goth the middle one?
It was D tier.
Oh, was it okay?
Yeah.
Well, I don't know. Does he even have a? I guess he does have Primarina who can set up pairs strong, but.
Yeah, I don't think that's what it's going for. I think the Gothita seems like a meme pick to me.
Yeah.
I don't have anything else on this one. Great. We got the Whitsett Wobbuffets. You got something else? Sorry.
No, the only thing I was going to say is he does have Intimidate on Scrafty. It's something we didn't mention, but otherwise, yeah, we can
move. It has Intimidate and Fake Out. It's a budget Incineroar.
Yep.
Then we got Whitsett Wobbuffets. With World. This is who you were talking to earlier, right?
This is what I was talking to earlier, so I can give you a little bit of insight. So, his first pick was Amoongus. That was the one he wanted the most. His second pick that he planned to get was Heatran. And when he didn't get Heatran, he kind of, like, panic-picked the Torkoal. And now, he's kind of, like, in a position now where he's like, man, what do I do with this Torkoal? Because he kind of unintentionally has, like, pretty close to a Trick Room heavy team here. And I don't know if you updated the sheet, but he did just trade out the Berserker for the Dusknoir to try to like lean into that.
Okay.
Lean a little bit. So Dusknoir obviously being a better option than the Grunt Pig because one, it's a ghost type. Mm-hmm. So you can't get faked out. Two, again, we mentioned earlier the value of Frisk. And then it has a few other things. I mean, it's a less bulky Dusclops, I guess, right?
Yep.
But a more budget option. So I mean, I agree with the pickup for Trick Room.
It also does decent damage on its own as well.
Yeah. So I mean, he could run what was it called Poltergeist, or mm-hmm. he could do what Dusclops does. He can do like Pain Split or Nightshade for damage if because he obviously is probably going to invest in bulk. We see the Dozo here. He's definitely like right now on the fence, like, man, do I pick up the Geary? He loves Sylveon though, so he like that's like the biggest like, man, I don't want to really get rid of Sylveon. And then like you said, a good fairy type is hard to come by. But obviously the Tatsugiri comp is a very valuable pick, right?
Mm-hmm. To be honest, I almost would have gone, I mean, he has the Trick Room like, option now, so that's why you like Dozo. But without that, I would prefer just Tatsugiri. He's on this team, being honest.
Mm-hmm. I mean, I think having both options is great. Again, it's a draft. Like, you force your opponent to have to guess what you're doing or encompass that within 6 months, and then you're probably going to have to, like, you know, let something go or not be super optimal with what you're covering. Mm-hmm. So I think it's good to have both. Again, he has to give up his probably favorite fairy type, and I don't know how well he can replace that from the fairy types that are left.
It's not great.
Which she also, I mean, granted, Sylveon in Trick Room, you know, great, right? 60, I think it's like 60 base speed, Pixelate, Hyper Voice, go burr. And then, of course, the Lilligant's there to pair with the Torkoal with the After You, gives them, you know, fast sleep powder.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. But I mean, that's the thing I was telling him. I was like, look, I don't know what your team wants to do. Like, it looks like it kind of wants to do Trick Room, but at the same time, you have like this kind of Sun Core. Ish, and I say core, I mean like two mons. Like if you want to do sun, like there should be at least another couple options to like at least threaten sun. Because right now it's just Lilligant Torkoal.
I would have liked one of the paradox mons. I think
I was thinking that too. I think the best one left right now is again a B tier pick, unfortunately, which would be a Great Tusk, which I think is underrated.
I think it would go really pretty well. He's got people flying, so you can Earthquake next to him.
Yeah.
Hmm.
It could be okay, but again, you give it that B tier pick, which might have been Tatsugiri at this point, right?
Yeah.
So I don't think there were really any other good Paradox Mons left on the table that would have gotten a benefit from this. I can fact check myself here if I type in Protosynthesis. I guess. I think literally Screamtail might be the only other one that's still available, which is not going to be an offensive threat. That's like a trick room mon in and of itself, which I guess kind of fits right down the middle. But the Screamtail. Yeah, so Screamtail and Great Tusk are literally the only two Protosynthesis mons left in the draft. So slim pickings.
Yeah.
He's got the, what do you call it? The my brain is Metroid pilled right now. I keep wanting to say Ravenbeak. Corviknight. He's got the Corviknight there, which is like the, I guess, anti-intimidate mon. But the only mon he's really protecting here is the Urshifu, I think, with that, right?
No, actually, he's not protecting anything.
Oh, Dozo.
He's a Staraptor. No, Dozo has Oblivious, or Unaware, I mean. So it can't be intimidated with Unaware.
Okay. Yeah, I believe. Fair enough. I'm trying to remember, because I know Unaware, you ignore your opponent's buffs. I think you ignore your own debuffs is how it works, right?
No, it's just you ignore your opponent's buff. I believe it stops, you don't get intimidated, I believe. It might just be Oblivious, so it's that one. They're the same, they're synonyms, maybe I'm just lying, I'm just spreading misinformation, but...
The description here is, if the Pokemon with this ability uses a damaging move or is targeted by a damaging move, the other Pokemon stat changes are ignored. So I think Intimidate is still a factor there.
Yeah, yes, it is. I was lying on the internet.
the Urshifu, I think that was just like an option that was like too good to like not pick at that point in the draft. He didn't pick it on his first pass. Again, he picked the... actually, I think it was his third pass by the time he got it. But yeah, like both bears were like when the draft went all the way through the first round, like both bears were still on the table. Rillaboom was still on the table, not for long, Tornadus Incarnate was still on the table. So it's like those were definitely like the prime picks that were like left over in my mind. So I think that was a great thing for him to pick up. Right, that's kind of an invaluable, you know, being able to not to punch and not have to worry about somebody protecting is pretty great. I don't know why I'm trying to like boost up, you know, Urshifu. Everybody knows what Urshifu does. But
I mean, yeah, you mentioned you protect it from Intimidate, but if you Wicked Blow, you ignore Intimidate anyways.
That's true. You're getting crits. So yeah, I think the Corviknight might be a miss. Which, you know, he might be doing some team adjustments here, so that might be one he could let go for sure.
And he already got rid of one of his steel, like his other steel types. So I think it's
well, that is another point.
Steel types, again, steel and fairies, both kind of hard to come by as good ones.
If only you could do that in one pick.
That's crazy. Imagine. But yeah, I mean, steel types kind of had a tax added to them where they're probably one tier more expensive than like the mon is actually worth just by having the steel typing on there.
Gotcha.
I predict we see a lot of Terra Steels in this draft league. Which
I don't see why not. Steel has like the most resistance of any type. So I mean, unless a team is, again, it's gonna be week to week specific. But I would agree with your statement.
I like his notable backmark abilities. Not really. That's the other thing.
That's one I wanted to pick up. But yeah, for sure, Magmar's great.
It's a very solid redirector.
With Flame Body, right? So you could pay the price, right? He also, something I picked up Electabuzz, very similar. Something else to point out is you have Vital Spirit. So like if you're going up against a team, well, he has the Amoongus, but like you go up another team that's got like Sleep, you can redirect it away and then not get penalized for it either, right? You don't have to use that item slot. He's going to have Eviolite, so you're not going to have the option of Safety Goggles. So it's nice to have the Vital Spirit option if the team you're playing against has like Spore or some other type of common hit. Or Sleep option, I guess. Like Yawn, I guess.
Yep.
So yeah, I think Magmar's a great pick. Honestly, I love Magmar. He's one of my favorite fire types. So like, I'm a little jealous, but like my first pick was Draft of Fire. So I love the duck, man. He's so cool. I hate his evolution, but now I'm getting off tangent here. But
Anyways, best pick of this draft is Staraptor, my goat. I hope he gets a success.
I think it will. And that's, so he's the one who sniped the Bruxious from Weaselman, and Weaselman was like, please, 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 please. So he was like, all right, we'll pick up Star Raptor, and then we'll make the trade. So yeah, Star Raptor gives him that Intimidate Mon. Yeah, I know that was one of your favorites from your singles draft. I think it's 100 base speed. Correct me if I'm wrong.
Yes, that's correct.
So it's like a decent, it's a decent tailwinding option. Not the best, but decent. Not that his team probably is going to be doing too many tailwinds. I think the only two, like, are obviously the Urshifu, and, like, maybe you could make Sylveon, like, abuse tailwind, but otherwise, his team's pretty slow.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Okay, fair enough.
I have one more thing to say about Grumpig. It has one of the most insane move pools I've ever seen. That's out of a Gen 1 Mon. You kind of know what you're getting with those. It has such like coverage across the board. It has like Energy Ball, Power Gem, Mystical Fire. It has like Shadow Ball, Dark Pulse, obviously, psychic coverage for psychic. It just has a lot of like moves you wouldn't necessarily expect. I think it's. I've used it in another previous draft. I think it's great. Mm-hmm. I'm so big on the pig.
Big on the pig. Fair enough. I mean, it's got some. I get own tempo, I guess, is and no, that's Oblivious I'm thinking of, so never mind. I guess you just run Thick Fat on this guy, but yeah. I don't know.
you go like Terra Grass, and then it gets rid of two of your weaknesses, and I think that's pretty awesome. It also can imprison Trick Room, so if you don't want to do a Trick Room 1 week, or if you go it's hard Trick Room, which you probably won't, well, you probably like that, because you have the Torkoal Amoongus, but...
I don't think anyone is going to Trick Room his team.
Yeah.
Nobody's planning to do that.
But yes, I do really like Grumpig. I think it's a great value pick. And the dumb bird is just it's there.
It exists. I think we're gonna have that a lot with the untiered mons, but we'll see.
Yep. Five. Right, and we're back with the inside Emboars. I had to take a little bit of a break for some other commitments and work and whatnot, but we're back. And that's why the music is different. No other reason. Anyways, we got the Eastside Emboars up next. So
yeah, left us on quite the cliffhanger. I really like the look of this team, at least aesthetically. But yes. Of course, this is a Sun team. So I think this is actually probably the potentially the strongest Sun team, even though he doesn't actually have... Well, okay, barring the Vulpix, he doesn't actually have like a drought like core. But I think Whimsicott 9 times out of 10 is a better setter for Sun anyways. But
I would agree.
Yeah,
I mean, think that especially
tailwind. Kind of, yep, go ahead. Sorry.
Oh yeah, especially with manual sun being able to shut down opposing weathers like way better is really nice. You have the priority always, obviously, and it's actually not that good for Venusaur in particular because you could also just set up tailwind, and it does the same thing for Venusaur. But for the Paradox Mons, it's great, and for Entei or not Entei, Gouging Fire is what it's called.
I believe that. Yep, that's correct.
Yes. You can boost the power of the fire-type moves pretty immediately. You also get to decide whether or not you want to do that. I think this is a really strong team.
Yeah, no, that monster is going to hit like a truck. I've seen a lot of coverage of teams with the Whimsicott and the Gouging Fire set, so I mean, I expect to see a lot of mileage out of that, but the way this team's set up, though, it does feel like he... pretty much has to set up Sun. Like, I mean, he could get around it, but his team is just so much better when the Sun's up. It's like he kind of has like a core thing that he's going for, which you know can hurt you if your opponent can play around a game plan. But he's got Trick Room right there in the A slot. He has his own Amoongus there and Brute Bonnet to work with that, so he does have a little bit of a backup strategy. I don't know what what's his name? Colossal does in this game. You know, I know in Gen 8 it did the I'm gonna Gigantamax and I'm gonna get chipped by, you know, a weak Mons Surf or, you know, Aqua Jet or something. And I'm gonna get the weakness policy off. I don't know if it can really do that role here.
But not super. Not really. It doesn't have a fast way to proc it, so I don't think it can really. He has the Quagsire, which can do it, but it's probably gonna take a little too much damage. I would not say it's probably worth it.
Yeah, I think the Quagsire is there just for, I guess, an unaware Mon. You go up, no one has the Dozo combo, so I don't know if that's necessarily a huge thing. But the, Water Absorb's okay. I mean, his only, Does he have... I guess Charizard and Vulpix are the only two that are really weak against water. Well, okay, and the four times with the coal.
No, colossal, I think my bigger fear here is, like, rock and ground types other than water. And that's... I mean, you have the three grass types, but he doubles up, or... A lot of typings are doubled up in this on this team, and quadrupled up in case of grass. So,
yeah, that's fair.
I will say, offensively, this team looks awesome. Defensively, I don't love it.
He might have a hard time pivoting Mons. Is that
yes? And there's defensive defensive typings. Something I've thought a lot about is the opportunity cost of using moves in draft. And this team, there is a very low opportunity cost of using ground or rock type moves because they're going to be so effective into most of the team. And flying, too, honestly. So there's only one flying resist and a lot of flying weaknesses. You got the two fighting types, four grass types, and the only resist is another fire type, of which you have three. Or four, actually. I forgot about Vulpix. So... a lot of the types overlapping means that you'll be hit by a lot of your Pokemon will be hit by the same moves, which makes it a lot easier to be confident running them when you're prepping. It's not like you're going to get hit by something off the wall, which I still think this team is very strong, but it's going to be easier to prep into than I think is desired.
It has a game plan. You know what it is. The game plan is still going to work, but at least you know what they're going for.
Yeah. It's a very strong game plan, and if you can't beat that game plan, well, you are in for a world of hurt. But if you figure out a unique way, or just have your own weather, like myself, in which case I have two, it's going to be a lot easier to just play around a lot of the Mons. And if you have if you have a flying type and a ground type, I think you'll be pretty good in this team. So.
I think ground types in general just look really solid. It's so hard to switch into ground types. I was noticing that when we were doing the actual draft, I was just like, man, unless you have like levitate or flying, like what are they? They can just launch a headlong rush or whatever, and it's gonna be pretty good. And he has the crest for that in that defense. Remind me, what's Slytherin's base speed? It's like, is it like 81 or something?
It's around there. It's not fast.
So it's not. He's probably getting an attack boost in the sun. But
yep.
Maybe choice scarf. I know choicing in especially in best 2 out of 3 is a little sketchy because if they learn it from one game, then it can be kind of easier to play around.
True, but if it helps you pick up a game, a game is a game, you know.
Yep.
Put you ahead.
And you don't have to bring it the other games either too. So you can get that surprise win and then put it back on the back. But I think the only other thing we haven't talked about is the Tauros. And I know like early VGC there was like an intimidate. Mirror Herb set that if you know your opponent has like a Defiant user, he might could bring.
Yes.
But,
I think that I really like the Tauroses. I don't love this one of this team because it doubles up on the typing again. Both of the types are covered by other Mons, but I still think it's a pretty good Mon. I just don't think I would ever bring it on the same team as Gouging Fire because they kind of do the same thing of hitting a hard, like, really strong physical fire type move. So.
Yeah, I kind of agree with that, because, I mean, I feel like you'd probably bring, you know, like you said, Gouging Fire over that. So, I mean, like, maybe picking up the water one, or even just, like, the regular one would have been a better option here, just to kind of spread out your switch-ins. But, either way, good to have an Intimidate Mon in the back.
Yeah, that's true. All right, we go next. Let's go down east on Dozos. Hydablo, Ryan.
Ah. Yes, him and I have a match that'll probably happen tomorrow night. But he's got a pretty scary team, not gonna lie. But Chimpao, obviously a threat, very fast, really good, just like not quite Bolt Beam level, but Dark Ice is just like hard to defend against. Let alone it has a Sacred Sword. Singing the praises of a mom that everybody already knows is good. I know.
Yeah.
But, the Lotties, however, I did not realize how cool they were, especially in a draft format. Like, obviously, I know what the Lotties do, but they have such cool tech.
I agree. I'm a big fan of them in regular VGC. It's Latias.
Yeah, Latias in this case, a little extra bulk, which is usually better if you're doing like a supporting role. Obviously, she has the Tailwind with 110 base speed, which I I guess barring the Chin Pao is his fastest. No, there's the bunny down there too. But the I think what else she's gonna do here. I have my, I have like a list.
Yeah.
Because I was like, go ahead.
So something that I have, things I like about this team, first of all, I like the Chin Pao combined with the Metagross and Breloom for your priority. Oftentimes you want to pair with E-Speed, Extreme Speed, but if that's not available, which it might not be in draft, then just having other like strong priority, physical priority in particular, to pair with it, it makes it for a very hard combo to stop. And Bullet Punch, Mach Punch, gonna hit from very hard. From the Breloom has like 130 attack. It's absurdly strong.
I used them on my relatively recent Emerald playthrough, and I was like, oh.
Yep. and Metagross, obviously, Pseudo Legend, everybody knows it's good.
I was completely heartbroken when he drafted this Mon, because that was on my radar of ones to pick up. So I was definitely disappointed.
There's a great value for B tier.
It's a great Mon. Like you said, steel types are hard to come by, and I think he's just one of the better ones. Like you said, Bullet Punch, you can do Assault Fest, you can run a cool weakness policy set. I don't think he has like a fast Bulldozer, but that's always fun. But that was more of a Gen 8 thing. But I love
Gyarados. Is probably your best bet with it.
Yeah.
Great. Yeah.
Yeah, true. Not really getting the value you want where you outspeed the other Mons and then make your Metagross outspeed. Yeah, not really happen. I mean, I guess you could do like Scarf Dose if you really wanted to for support. That's strange. Yeah. The Tinglu, that's an interesting Mon too. You know, you can do the it's like the one Mon where you run Fissure and it's not terrible because he's just so bulky. You run Fissure, Stomping Tantrums. If you miss the Fissure, then you're at least doubling up. So definitely can cheese out games with that Mon. Otherwise, I guess it just kind of helps him with Special Bulk, right? That drops Special Attack.
Yeah. I don't love Tinglu. So the problem with Tinglu and Chien Pao on the same team, even though I think it's funny to have two Treasures of Ruin. Defensively, they don't pair well together because they're both dark. And
I think
you don't
the first
really
three in general, right? I mean, he's got three like the first three Mons he has up there are all weak to Fairy, right?
Yeah. And you got the Metagross to deal with that, but overall, it's still a very Fairy weak team. And you got the Moltres, which will help with that, but you don't. And you kind of have Cinderace, but not really, because it often changes its type, and it's also not that bulky in the first place. So
yeah, I think unless he's going up against a Sun team, I think that Metagross is a staple every week.
Mm-hmm. I would agree. It seems like the cornerstone of the team.
He's so cool.
I love things that I like. I like the defensive core of Latias, Tinglu, and Pachirisu, actually. I think it's pretty neat. The things you, unfortunately, the times that you kind of want Pachirisu on the field, obviously you want it for Volt Absorb, for taking the electric types from the Gyarados, and you can follow me, redirect them. But also you kind of want it next to Latias, but also it's a really great defensive pairing, but it's a bad offensive one. It's very passive. That's actually my biggest issue with the team, is a lot of it is very passive. Tinglu is pretty passive, Latias is pretty passive, Pachirisu is very passive. Decidueye is not super passive, but it's not as strong as you would like oftentimes, and it's not fast. And Moltres is pretty passive.
I don't even like using Decidueye in a playthrough. Like, he's my favorite of that gen starters, but he is so miserable to use. He can do stuff, but he's just so slow. Like, I just don't know what his usage is, right?
The other thing that I'm scared about with this team is that you set up a Reflect, and the team...
Oh, no, I agree. It's very physically forward. Like, the only thing that's a special hitter is, like, the Lottie, right? And I guess Moltres, but... which I think Moltres is a pretty good bargain pick for D tier. Like, that's still, like, a legendary bird stat.
It's got a lot of stats, yeah.
Yeah. Gyarados, obviously, you can run it either defensively... which was like his main shtick when he picked it up. He was like, oh yeah, you know, Thunder Wave. But then his very next pick was the Pachirisu. And I'm like, okay, you know what you're doing here. Like, if you pick up the Pachirisu, you're putting it in your back pocket that you can do with a Dragon Dance set. Like, so yeah, he definitely has both those options, right? Yeah. And then of course everyone has to respect Breloom because he has Spore, so.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Weasel, I think, was just a cutesy pick. Whimsicott's baby there can do... what is it? It's cotton down, I guess, as a budget cotton spore. Thank you, as a budget tailwind option because it still has prankster. Yeah. I think it still gets encore, so it's still solid. It's still solid.
Yeah. It's definitely worse than Whimsicott, but for untiered instead of S tier, you know, you take what you can get.
Yeah. And then I guess the Cinderace, it kind of just, it exists, right? It's a good mon in singles. It can certainly do things in doubles. It just is not really a specialist at anything. It just, I guess, it exists.
Yeah, it's the second fastest pawn on the team. It's gonna be strong, I think. And I mean, paired with the Sword of Ruin, it'll be picking up some KOs you never thought possible.
True, so. It does make it stronger for sure.
Yeah, once again, my big fear is just you invest into defense pretty much primarily, and then you set up a reflect either or, and this team it seemed like it would struggle to break through.
Yeah, I mean, I'm trying to think what so Metagross has Psychic Fangs now, which is nice. It's a nice buff Metagross that'll help him with if someone wants to put up a reflect. I'm almost 100% certain you get Brick Break on Breloom, maybe on a couple of the other ones there too. But yeah, I think Metagross having Psychic Fangs will be definitely something he keeps in his pocket. I mean, he should anyways.
Yes.
Of course, I mean, it's his best psychic move, so it doesn't hurt to head run it.
Yep. All right. Next up, we got the Oak City Obstagoons. And this is, I mean, a good, great logo, first of all. I love this one. It's very funny.
Thank you.
But I think that this team is okay.
All right.
It is not.
We'll break it down here.
Yeah.
It's not cohesive. No,
I have more to say than that, but primarily I see a lot of decent mons. A problem with a lot of them is that they are none of the mons I look at and say, oh yeah, that's the good value mon, or that's like a really high power mon for the tier. Everything is kind of, oh, that's an average Pokemon in the tier. That makes sense. That's a decent pick for all the way down the list.
What a strange thing to say, like, in the aspect of, like, forever, right? For Lando to be there and say he's underwhelming, right? Like, he was the premier intimidator for, like, maybe four generations. Like,
well, the problem is I really don't like four kinds of weaknesses in draft. And he has got three of them in the top four picks.
I see what you're saying.
So they're good Pokemon, but I don't think they're like that great value for draft. I think that's what I'm trying to say.
The other problem is you know, your S, your A's, and even your B's, typically you're going to be your like more offensive threats, and they share a lot of common weaknesses here. You see the first three are all weak to water. The second, third, and fourth are all weak to fighting, including the fifth, actually. They're all weak to fighting. So yeah, just in his strong mons, like you know the moves you need to pack on your team to make sure you can be effective.
Yep. But that said, I mean, the mons that he has are still good, right?
Yeah. I see the Ursaluna. I'm like, okay, there's a Trick Room plan in here somewhere, right? And I'm not seeing like a very obvious good Trick Roomer. Like I see mons that get it, but they're not very bold.
Yeah.
Right.
Comfey and Espeon, or Trick Room setters. I think that, honestly, I think it's going to be more of a Tailwind. They set it up under Tailwind. Kind of strat.
Does the bear himself, does he set up Trick Room?
No.
No, okay.
So I think that primarily I think what we're going to see is either Comfey or Hydreigon setting up Tailwind. And then, because Ursaluna, it's 52 speed. Which is not actually that slow. It's not like a great. It's not super slow under Trick Room, and it's fast enough that like even under Tailwind, you still outspeed Dragon Bolt if you need to.
The only problem with that is you do have to invest in that speed at that point, so you do lose a lot of bulk.
Right, but
whereas
if you're
Trick Room, you can just avoid the full attack and just
that's true. But I think it's the best way to abuse it just on this team. It's going to be in Tailwind other than Trick Room. And also the pairing with Comfey, you miss out on the bulk, but you get healing in return.
Remind me how Comfey's ability works. He gets priority on healing moves? Is that what it is?
Moves that recover HP. So like Giga Drain, Draining Kiss, But also
does
stuff
he get life
like
due?
I don't know. I haven't used it since Life 2 came out.
Or it's got to get like Heal Pulse or something.
Yeah,
right?
Yeah, but yes, Heal Pulse it, and okay. Or I think it has a it's like flower. It is a special signature move.
Oh, okay. I'm not a Comfey expert. So.
Which is just it's just Heal Pulse, but in grassy terrain it heals more.
Okay. Okay.
If you wanna be a Comfey expert, go to Cybertron's channel and search Comfey, yeah? And you will see a 3-part series featuring a team that I may or may not have built.
Oh, okay. You are the Comfey expert. Okay.
I actually am. I love Comfey. It's one of I hadn't used it in Gen 9, so I don't know what new stuff it got.
So I mean, you mentioned something about getting a boost in grassy terrain. Does that mean it usually likes to be paired with something like Rillaboom?
Not really. It goes from like a 50% healing to 75% healing, which is like nice.
So good.
Also importantly, it has a +3 priority to healing moves. If you are faster than your opposing fake out, you will move before the fake out.
That is very important.
It's the same priority bracket. And it moves like stuff. It moves before also before follow me, so they cannot redirect your heal pulse or their floral healing away.
Oh
from
gosh,
you.
I didn't even think about follow me and heal pulse. That's hilarious.
But yes, Comfey does not have to worry about that.
Well, let's see what else we got here. So we have Espeon. Yeah, could be a
enough of me
player.
Gushing about Comfey.
Yeah. But yeah, Espeon could be a screen setter. You know, its magic bounce ability is kind of whatever here, I think. I'm trying to think what in VGC is applicable to magic bounce.
It's nice for like, stopping taunt. It also gets it from the trick room.
Yeah, I guess that's a good point. She can't be taunted out of setting up screens, right?
Mm-hmm. Correct. You also, if you're up against Spore or anything like that, you bounce it back.
Yeah.
Any status
that is
actually
kind of dirty. Yeah, unfortunately, you bounce back forward, probably not putting something to sleep unless it's terrestrialized. But, I mean, I guess there's Smear Girl in this draft, so if he goes up against the Raticates, that could be a real thing. Let's see, you got Hariyama's got Fake Out and Bullet Punch, and I don't know what else that Mon does.
It can do either Thick Fat if you're playing, against the Sun Team. You probably want to do that.
True.
It also, you can do Guts with Flame Orb, and it just hits like a truck.
Okay.
It's mostly just, I think it's mostly there for the fake out support, because that's his only fake outer. And it's a decent one for the C tier. But like I said, everything is decent.
Sure. Tentacruel is one of my favorite mons to use in singles. Just has like a lot of utility, has a lot of the cool things it can do. In doubles, I couldn't think of a good reason for me to draft it. So when he picked it up, I can't really be disappointed because I don't know what I would do with him. But and maybe there is some little, I'm sure it gets screens or something, but I guess he just didn't have a good water type at that point. So maybe he was looking to draft a water.
This was, he also looked like he needed a poison type. He didn't have other than Heatran, he didn't have a great fairy type matchup.
That's a good point. Yeah.
This is another fairy resist.
He's got a ton of... Yeah, that's a good point. And then, let's see. Crocolore is like a, you know, obviously it's just a baby. Skeledirge, you have the Unaware. You're not going to have... I mean, I guess you could make it work. I mean, it's untiered, right? So, I mean, you're going to get what mileage you can out of it.
Yeah.
The, Fortress, kind of the same vein. Does Fortress do anything?
Fortress
special
explodes.
I guess. Does he? But he doesn't really have the other thing is he doesn't really have a ghost type to like pair that with. I mean, he's either got the Terra Ghost or does anybody in here have telepathy?
I don't think so.
Yeah. Yeah. So maybe might be a little awkward to position.
Mm-hmm.
And then I guess you have Accelroc on the Lycanroc. I guess Rock Slide's always good. It's a fast Rock Slider, so I mean,
it's brittle. Rock Slider.
Yeah. Then again, you have Lando up there. You can just be Scarf Lando and do that.
Actually, I think.
So
that Lycanroc has Tough Claws, so you actually don't really want to be doing Rock Slide. You want to be using contact moves as much as you can. None of the good Rock moves are contact moves. So it's just an awkward Pokemon to use.
That's fair. I mean, I guess, I don't know. Yeah. And then I guess the only thing we skipped over are the dark types, which I guess you did mention quickly the Tailwind option from Hydreigon, and then Meowscarada, it's a cat, so it makes me want to think it has Fake Out, but I've never seen it do it.
It does not
think it has Fake Out.
Not
okay.
Fake Out.
I feel like every cat has Fake Out, but except Meowscarada. But what does Meowscarada do in doubles? I remember it was big early on.
So, yeah, I mean, it was very good in VGC for the first season, for first format, I guess. Then as soon as Paradox Mons came in, it immediately got crept out of the format by exactly Fluttermane. Fluttermane is single-handedly keeps this Mon from any sort of viability. So in a drop format, I think, yeah, I mean, that's true. Fluttermane's insane. But in draft, I think it's actually one of the more, I think it's probably the best value pick on the team. I think it could easily be an A tier, and given, like, if people voted, like, people thought higher of it if it didn't have that tech and it didn't have that such bad matchup in Flutter. It's very fast, and then Flower Trick is an incredible move. It's such a strong move. Oh my god.
Always crits too, right? So you
always crits, never misses.
Like, I don't care about intimidate, you kind of thing.
Yep. And it goes through screens, it goes through boosts. So it was really good into Dondozo, because you just crit through the all the boosts and you would kill it. Anyways, but yeah,
I think
it has Trick Room as well. I guess it's a third Trick Room user.
Okay, well that was something I was asking about earlier, was Trick Room. So that's an option for it. I think something else worth mentioning, and I noticed this when we did the singles draft because I got stuck with Arbeliva, is it's kind of awkward to find a good grass type outside of Sun, right? And I think Meowscarada is like one of those, right?
I agree. I had it last draft in the singles draft league.
True,
I thought it was quite good.
Yep.
But yeah, it loses some of the utility from singles because you're not doing any hazards. So, like, being able to set up spikes or toxic spikes doesn't help it at all in doubles. But it's still a very good Mon.
Yeah, nothing against Meowscarada for sure.
Right, you have anything else for this team?
No, I don't think so.
All right. We got the Red Oak Raticates. This is a team that I am intimately familiar with.
If you've been playing Pokemon since Generation 4 and back, I mean, that these are all buddies, right? So, I mean, again, nothing on his team is after Gen 4.
Yep.
Which, I guess that tells you a lot. But, I mean, either way, a lot of great Mons here. So, I mean, Dragonite, obviously a great super deep move pool because it's from Gen 1. You get the E-Speed, Inner Focus, so it can't be intimidated. So, great Mon. You have the Zapdos, who's always good. Doesn't matter the format. You know, it only has two weaknesses. Can set up, I believe it sets up Tailwind, right?
It does. Or it used to. I think, I mean, it does. It definitely does. It's a TM now. So,
yeah, exactly. Porygon 2, a heartbreaker for me. That one got stolen from me that round. I love Porygon 2. Porygon 2, I mean, obviously it's a Pokemon that stood the test of time. Slap an Evilite on it. You got Bolt Beam coverage. Probably one of the best Trick Room Mons out there because it doesn't have to be on Trick Room. It can sit there and just be bulky, put on a good offensive presence with the download ability. I could gush about Porygon 2. Yeah, and then there's the demon right next to it, Smeargle, which is like...
Hate him.
Yeah, well, yeah, I hate to see games lost because of Moody. Or like, they're just getting like speed boost back to back. I think they did take the accuracy, or it's going to be the evasion boost out. So at least that's no longer a thing.
Mm-hmm.
What a menace.
I just get war flashbacks from VGC 2016 when it was like a top five Mon.
Dark Void?
Yes, oh my god. People ran Choice Scarf on it just to make it just click Dark Void.
I mean, if you get the double sleep, that's pretty much GG, right?
Yeah.
I mean,
so next to Xerneas, when you set up your Geomancy, God. Anyways, in this generation, it can't do that anymore because it can learn Dark Void, and Dark Void got nerfed.
But you know, it's always getting new tools because every time a new move comes out, Smeargle gets a buff, right? So I mean, now I think the newest thing it's going to be running is the Burning Bulwark move that Gouging Fire has, the Burn Protect.
Mm-hmm.
Probably a pretty standard readable set. So that Spore, what else would you want to run on this guy?
Fake Out,
maybe Tailwind. Fake Out for sure.
Literally whatever you want, it can do anything.
Yeah.
But, yeah, so something that I've noticed about this team is because it is so many old Pokemon, they get the good moves, but everyone kind of knows what they do, so you don't have any of the surprise factor. Which could be good, could be bad. It makes it easier for building, because you know what you're going to do, but it also kind of makes it easier for your opponent. So if you can outplay your opponents, if you can play better, then I think this is a very strong team. But if you can, you also can kind of get outbuilt in the big building phase of it.
Yeah, this team's not on my schedule, but I know if I was playing versus them, I would definitely pack some ice moves around on my team. You see the double ice weakness. You got Zapdos.
Yep.
But Garchomp, you know, Amon, that's definitely to the test of time. B actually might be too low for it. I mean, I know it's gotten pushed out by things like you said, the Fluttermane. I think this is probably it was criminally low tiering for him. 102 base speed, excellent rock slider. I guess he can pair it with Zap. He's got Zapdos and Dragonite that he can pair it with for the Earthquake. Granted, pairing up Dragonite again, the double quad ice weakness is just asking to get icy winded or something. But the it's great, Mon. It always will be.
I don't have too much to say. Around the rest of the team. Actually, something I noticed is it has two of the best trick room setters, and there's no way to use it, which is so sad.
Who's the second?
Porygon and Spiritomb.
Spiritomb, okay.
Spiritomb is one of the things. It's the best D tier trick room setter.
And here's what I'll say about Porygon. I don't think Porygon has to be on a Trick Room team to run Trick Room.
Doesn't.
Like, it's just one of those. Like, if you just want to. If you see your opponent just has faster mons than you, you're like, all right, well, I'll click the funny TR button. And there you go.
And Dragonite doesn't care. It just puts tree speed.
Yeah. I think the only. Like you said, the other mons are kind of awkward to talk about. I think the only other one that we probably should say a couple things about maybe is Blastoise. You have Fake Out. He has the potential.
Also Shell Smash.
I was about to say he could do Shell Smash, and he could technically run Focus Sash, like Follow Me, Smeargle, to kind of assist with that if he really wanted to. So I think Blastoise could have opportunity to do something.
He could do like Choice Scarf Water Spout as well. It's a thing.
Yeah. Yeah, very true.
Great. I don't have too much else to say about this one.
I guess the other thing I will say is he does have 150. He has a very cheap Regieleki option with the 150 base speed Electrode with Electro-Whip, right?
That's true.
That's notable. All right, now I've said my piece.
Okay. Next up, we got Tomba and then New York Ninetales.
All right, our first rain team, right? That we've looked at so far?
Well, no.
I guess you technically have some rain. Excuse me.
Technically.
How could I forget?
I have nothing going on. Nearly hard rain team. It's multi-weather, but yes, the other rain team in the draft.
This is the rain team with the water bear, as a matter of fact. Mm-hmm. So definitely a threatening team. Just seeing the Urshifu is going to make people want to run Rocky Helmet on one of their mons, right? Mm-hmm. To try to whittle this thing down. Urshifu, obviously a giant threat that
I hate it.
Needs reminding of.
Oh, I hate it. I ran into it too much at Charlotte Regionals. I don't like it.
Are you going to pull a Wolfie Glick and give me a whole video about how Unseen Fist is super unhealthy? Is that?
I could do it. I could talk for even longer than Wolfie did. I do not like this Pokemon, but it's very good, and the team is better for it.
Yeah. Definitely a mon that I arguably shouldn't have let get away from me, but... I had the option of both bears amongst other good things. And I still got something good. But the bears are just crazy good. You see he's got it paired with Thundurus, who can do Prankster Rain Dance to further support him in that endeavor. Honestly, I think this version of Thundurus is just very cool. If you go up against like a team that has like Spore users, you can do Prankster Electric Terrain, which is really funny. But that he also has
to protect himself.
That's true. He is flying. I didn't think about that. That's a very good point. But you also have he has two paradox or future paradox mons that would be relevant to as well. Mm-hmm. So he can boost Iron Thorns and Iron Valiant with that strat. So that's neat. It is surprising. Maybe not. I was about to say it's surprising he didn't get Archeludon. I think it's even more surprising the team that picked up Tornadus did not pick up Archeludon. Either way, that mon went undrafted, which is, I mean, he's a new pawn, so I wanted to see what it would do, but I think it's very cool.
I have in my other draft league, I'm going to say it's incredible. It's so good. But the thing that I like I actually don't love the rain component. It's kind of it's definitely a softer rain team. I'm also a lot lower on Bascu Legion than a lot of people are. I think that Pokemon is kind of mid. And actually, the female version, it's just not
strong. Special, right?
Yeah, but you kind of still want to do Wave Crash. It's still your best move, so you kind of have to go physical. It's weird. It's a weird mon to use, and it has adaptability as well. If you want to do that, which adaptability with Terastal is very good because you get the 2x boost for the new type that you switch into as well.
Okay.
And keep your 2x boost for your Ghost and Water. So it's a neat. It's a really good ability.
Its physical attack's actually not that bad. It's sitting at 92 compared to its special attack at 100. So not the worst thing in the world.
But I also really like Superior in the draft with Stellar Terra. I think it's so funny.
Now Stellar Terra makes it so you get stab on one type once each or something.
Yes.
Okay. However, so why is that actually funny?
So what it does, it's funny because what it does with the Terra Blast, so it turns Terra Blast into a neutral type move that just hits everything. It hits everything neutral except for other Terastalized Pokemon, which it hits with super effective damage. It makes it base 100 instead of base 80, and it also lowers your attack and special attack by one stage. However, if you have Contrary, it boosts
Okay. Well, okay. Now you brought that up. The main combo with this mon is, again, the Thunderous and the Prankster. Was it Eerie?
Eerie Impulse.
Yes. You can immediately get the +2 Leaf Storm. You're already at +4. So, I mean, this mon could, if allowed, it could do some serious damage. That remains to be seen whether it will.
Yeah, the problem with Superior is really just its stats hold it back tremendously.
Yeah. It definitely has to get, you know, a Contrary boost off before it really becomes a threat. And it doesn't really have a lot of... And maybe this changed in this generation. I don't feel like it has a lot of coverage outside of Terra Blast, right? I mean, a Lost Hidden Power...
It has Dragon-type coverage, Blast-type coverage, and Terra Blast.
Yeah. So, not a great move pull. On the flip side, a great move pull and a mon that I really enjoyed. Actually, I think in my first draft league, he's got Gardevoir up there, which, again, deep move pull... It has so many cool little tech things. I'm so sad that Showdown lost replays. I had my favorite replay, and it involved Gardevoir doing cool things. Really cool draft mon. I'm a big fan. Obviously the Pelipper is rain, tailwind support.
I am a little bit scared that he got baited into the Raichu and Iron Thorns, because that seems like it's such a juicy combo down in D tier. You're not really spending that much on it. Unfortunately, Iron Thorns. It sucks so hard. It is really bad. I was tempted to vote for it in untiered whenever I was part of the tier list decision. It's not good.
So sad because it looks really cool.
I know,
but
how can you make Tyranitar bad? They did it somehow.
You bring up. I mean, the more we talk about it, I led into this team saying, "Hey, this is a rain team." This honestly feels more like I could say this is an electric terrain team. Because, again, you have the Paradox Mons, you have Alolan Raichu sitting right there, gets his ability off the Electric Terrain. I think it's equally Electric Terrain as it is Rain.
Yeah, the unfortunate part is that Electric Terrain is bad. Spending a turn setting up Rain is not unless, that bad. Spending a turn setting up Electric Terrain.
If your team plays to it, it's not the worst thing in the world. But I agree. You're not getting the double
electric
effect.
Terrain
you're not
good
getting an psychic terrain. You get no priority moves, or if it's but electric terrain is no sleep. Electric moves are better. So it's very niche. If he goes up against an opponent that has four mons, great. Now it's got two purposes, right? Mm-hmm. But I'm with you on that.
And also, because it also benefits other Paradoxmon, future Paradoxmons on opposing teams.
Now that's a good question. What are the other? Let me look up Quark Drive. So I guess against Glist, he probably would not want to boost Iron Hands. No. I don't think Crown or Bundle got picked up. Boulder didn't get picked up. Iron Moth did get picked up. That's the thing, is a lot of the Quark Drive Mons went undrafted. So there's not a lot of teams he has to worry about. Again, it's probably the Moth in the hands.
Mm. Yeah, okay.
I like the
philosophy of this team of like just picking up just high statted Mons. Everything except for like Pelipper and Clodsire, I guess, are generally pretty high just base stat total. I think it's just a solid philosophy.
Well, I guess we haven't really talked about the glass cannon up there in A tier, which I don't think is a very common VGC face.
It is not. But it is one of those that remain. Keeps out
put down.
Format.
Yeah. It's, but I mean, it's going to have, you know, I'm pretty certain that the Paradox Mons get all, or at least close to all, of the same moves that their base forms get. So it probably has a big bag of tricks like Gardevoir has. And again, whatever Gallade has too.
Yeah.
It has
a pretty nice move pool.
Definitely a valuable thing in draft to have options like that. So can make it hard to make yourself hard to predict. Also give you the chance to have a lot of coverage options. So I do think it is worth the A tier title in a draft format.
It's actually got a surprisingly deep support move pool as well. I had it in one of my drafts previously. And that's what I used it for more often than as an offensive threat.
No, that's great. I mean, that's a great thing to. I mean, if you can be a supportive Mon, but also be a threat, like that's one of the big problems with Pokemon like Whimsicott, is if you get yourself in a weird spot where your opponent can just ignore Whimsicott, then all of a sudden Whimsicott is not helping and you're doing a bunch of 2v1s for the rest of the match.
Yep.
Whimsicott, obviously one of the stronger prankster support Mons, but I mean, it's really usually relegated to like Moonblast for like coverage.
You really don't want to have all my friends are dead syndrome. And this is a...
Exactly.
Yeah.
This Mon says, my friends are dead, but you know, I'm still here.
So are you.
Don't party yet. Yeah. The a cool pickup he did right before the preseason ended was he did pick up Magmortar. I forget what... Actually, on your screen that you're sharing right now, you probably have... What is next to Superior on your screen?
Oh, I have Goodra next to Superior on my screen.
Okay. So he dropped the Goodra for Magmortar, which I think is a great...
I was actually the one that told him to do that. That's funny.
Oh, okay. So this is you. So, yes. So, obviously, that gives him a follow me user, which he didn't have. I think it's really funny. Obviously, it works better for Magmar because it gets a little bit more bulk. But the follow me flame body. Yeah, that's fantastic. Just being an offensive threat, like Magmar himself, just having like overheat, and then this thing with a much higher special attack. Like, you are still a threat.
Yes.
So I definitely agree with this pickup. He didn't have fire coverage before. Again, we mentioned this is kind of a soft rain team. He doesn't have to run rain, though. And I think having a fire type is certainly great. So now, that gives him a fire, grass, water core there. You have the bear, you have the snake, and you have whatever they turn to Magmar.
What I told him before, he said, you're telling me about Magmortar. Other than being a fire type with redirection, what else does it do? I'm seriously considering it. I said, it pretty much does everything that Magmar does, redirects, helping hands, can sleep, rest talk, break Will-O-Wisp, but it also has much higher special attack and incredible coverage, which Magmar does not. And it still has good coverage, but not as good. Which, all the fire moves,
Thunderbolt,
Scorching Sands, Psychic, Acid Spray, and Focus Blast.
Now you mentioned, I thought I heard you say something about sleep talk in there. What was that? I missed that part.
Rest talk. It gets sleep talk along with rest. So if you want to do a really bulky one and just have like your moveset be like rest, sleep talk, heat wave, and like soul mind or something, you can just makes it very hard to kill and you just get all your health back. It's not a super common set, but it's around.
Okay. The on the flip side of that, because you couldn't use this ability with that particular strategy, it does have the option of having Vital Spirit, which can come into play again if you're going up against a Spore team. you can say, hey, follow me, and the spore comes at him and can't do anything. So it's a good option to add.
Yep. All right. Next up, we got Kane and Tarboro Tatsugiris. I like this team. I think it has a lot of fun mods.
It does have a lot of cool things. The Ogrepan obviously being one of the newer toys. Was it Ivy Cudgels, the high crit move? It's got, what does this thing have? Fake Out? I haven't really been in the game.
Follow me.
Follow me. That's what it is.
It can set up itself with Swords Dance. I just used it in Charlotte Regionals, and I'm using it again.
The Water Form?
In Water Form. I'm using it in a tournament coming up. But I think it's neat. Water Grass is a really good defensive typing. Then obviously with the Terra, it gets the boot, special defense boost, makes it really bulky. But yes, Ivy Cudgel becomes a Water type move, and it's paired with either Wood Hammer or Horn Leech, depending on if you want the raw power or the sustain. And then it usually do Spiky Shield. It has Follow Me as well. It has Swords Dance, just some variation of those. It has probably 7 or 8 moves that are all really solid on it. And you basically just have to predict which 4 they bring. And if you get it wrong, then you're just owned.
Yeah. I mean, the nice thing about at least prepping against that mon is it's probably going to only have... Well, no, that's not true, actually. It has a pretty good move pool, right? It has stuff like Play Rough, and it has some type coverage.
Yeah. The problem with its coverage, though, is you can't terrestrialize into it, so it's always going to not have stab.
Yep. Right. Yep.
Then we got Entei. I'm a known hater of.
You're a hater of? You don't think it's good, or you hate going up against it?
I don't think it's good. Had it in a previous draft league, and I burn in the entire league. I got 4 burns with it, and I missed 3 times.
It's 95. Sacred Fire is 95 accurate, right? And then it has 50% chance to burn.
Yes.
Okay, so you have some personal grudge against this monster.
Yeah.
Obviously, it's still good. You have inner focus. You can't be intimidated. You have extreme speed, so you have the priority. Obviously, a really strong mon. So, just generally good. Just with those 2 mons, he kind of has his fire, water, grass core. It's kind of strange. Yeah. And then he has his next 2 picks, which I think... I can't remember if he got these back-to-back. I know Moltres was his third round 3 pick. But he's got 2 dark types right back-to-back, which seems kind of strange for A and B tier. I feel like he maybe could have had a little bit more type variety there. But they're both good mons, don't get me wrong. Roaring Moon, 119 base speed, so a good Tailwinder that's not Prankster. Strong, has the breaking swipe, so if you need to knock the attack down of both your opponent's mons, it can snarl, so if you're going against a special attack heavy team, you could certainly do that. Same thing, it's a strong supporting mon.
The most common set in regular VGC with the Terra Flying, boost your energy, boost your acrobatics.
Yep.
Hits super quite hard. Hitting.
Yep. Then,
and most importantly, he has my goat Minior. I love Minior. I think it's so funny.
Shield's down, right? So you're super bulky. You take when you're half health? What is it?
Yes. When the shields go down. 50%.
Okay. I don't know how often we'll see that thing go, but
I hope we see it at least once. I think it's so cool. Anyways, he has some other of my favorite mons from previous games. He has half of my all cat team that I made in Sword and Shield once that got featured on Cybertron. I was pushing a little bit with Mie and Shao. I don't know how much that really counts.
To be fair, okay, I see what you're saying. Not really. It's more of a weasel, I guess.
Yeah.
We'll count it for now.
I had Meowstic and Mie and Shao and Jolteon and Incineroar instead of Torracat.
Yeah. Well, and Torracat obviously being a budget Incineroar in this case, but you still get the Intimidate, you still get the Fake Out. So, yeah, good. A solid option.
It's also faster than Incineroar, so which is something to note.
Well, Yeah, Cinderor should have stayed on four legs, but, you know, it is what it is. The speaking of a bargain variant, he has the Jolteon, which is the bargain Aleki. So you're not rocking 200 base speed, but 130 is still a lot to get off a quick Electroweb.
Mm-hmm. It gets both Charm and Eerie Impulse on base 130 yeah. speed, which is really nice. You can cripple yeah. whatever opponent.
Yeah, he doesn't have. Speed. Yeah. Oh yeah, because that drops special attack. That's true. Yep. It also got a buff. Well, I would say all the special attack EVs got a buff because they all got access to Alluring Voice.
Yes.
So, you know, having an 80 base coverage. Power coverage for parry at on 130 base speed mon with, I think, 110 base special attack. Just great buff for Jolteon and Glaceon and, I guess, Vaporeon. Min Xiao, great toolbox mon, fake out, both quick guard and wide guard. Access to the new upper hand move, which I don't know. That's kind of a high risk.
It's a bad
kind of a high risk move. Trying to think. I'm a big Min Xiao fan. I'll go ahead and say it. I actually didn't draft it because I had the typing already kind of covered on my team, but and the roles for that matter. But I think that's a very good mon. Great C tier pickup. Again, your other cat you were talking about, Meowstic, is his little prankster mon. Doesn't have Tailwind, but has access to Thunder Wave to kind of get a pseudo speed control there.
It also has Prankster Screens, importantly.
Prankster Screens. It has a few other cool... I think it has Encore as well.
Mm-hmm. And it gets Charm as well.
Yeah, so definitely a cool mon, good C-tier pickup. And then I know you're a big fan of picking up a Steel-type. All Steel-types, you said, are... kind of valued a tier maybe higher because steel's a commodity to pick up. Ready steel obviously is, I guess, kind of like a iron defense body press kind of mon, but I don't know what else it does.
Yeah, that's it. That's what it does.
Okay.
And
fair
also,
enough. And I got...
only other thing I have, shout outs to my boy Gengar for falling off so hard that it managed to fall into C tier. That's all I have to say about that one.
I mean, this Paris Trap's bad. It doesn't have Levitate anymore. Poor Gengar. I guess he can sit out there with Registeel and do Sledge Wave or something. I don't know. But doesn't it have any supporting moves? Or is it just a fast offensive? I mean, I guess
it's
Icy Wind. Yeah. Okay. He does. And, you know, funny enough, he does have a couple of Parasong mons with Gengar and Lapras.
Yep.
Lapras gives him access to freeze dry. I guess he can do some funny things with. I guess he has prankster gravity with Meowstic, so he could do like sing or hypnosis, right?
That's true. Yeah. That's pretty strong.
Yep.
All right. Next up, we got Eternal Victinis. This team is scary, might I say. It is... Regieleki and Chiyu on the same team is... That's so strong.
That's a lot of special damage coming your way.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, Electroweb and then Heat Wave, then it's going to do a ton. Especially with Chiyu's ability, just going to do a ton.
Yep.
You could you could just do Specs Chiyu in that situation if the matchup looked right for it. Because, I mean, the sheer amount of damage you're going to be doing is going to be hard to defend.
Indeed. I don't love a lot of the rest of the team. A lot of it kind of lacks offense, and it lacks ways to abuse the Chiyu, which I don't love. You got a lot of physical attackers for a team with Chiyu, you know?
Yeah, but, I mean, Gudra can get some extra attack prior to that because it's usually a bulky mon, so that does kind of help it out. I'm not going to say obviously because Gudra's got a big move pool, but I feel like one of the better sets is going to be quote unquote physical with, again, iron defense or what's his ability?
Shelter.
Or a move, shelter. Does the exact same thing, right?
Yeah.
Okay. So, yeah, shelter, body press. But yeah, again, it has the flexibility of running. Probably like Thunderbolt and Flamethrower, unless it lost those. But
no, it has those. It's just Beads of Ruin is reciprocal. So, like, it'll also be less especially bulky.
Oh, yeah, that's true. That is true. Yeah, I didn't think about that. It does have good abilities, though. I think it still has Sap Sipper in that form, right? It's sweet. Yeah, yes. So it has Sap Sipper. What's the other useful ability? Shell Armor's anti-crit. Yeah, you're probably going Shell Armor unless your opponent says, oh, I have Spore member on my team. And then you're like, okay, well, time for the safe Sap Sipper. Or, I guess if you're going up against Chlorophyll Sleep Powder as well. But, that's a great... It's good when your mon has a bunch of abilities that you can like switch in and out for draft. So yeah, I think it's definitely a very solid pickup for him.
Yep.
Ogrepan, same thing that we copy and paste what we said about the other one, other than the fact that this one's ability is what?
Defiant.
Okay. Pheasantipity, what does that do?
I think Pheasantipity's a neat Pokemon. It has a lot of like neat support moves, and its Toxic Chain ability is neat with all the spread moves it gets, you know, like an Icy Wind and Dazzling Gleam. It also has Beat Up to basically guarantee Toxic onto something. But Toxic is just not that good in VGC. It's the problem. It has a niche, and it's also like Poison Fairy is only other Pokemon with it is Galarian Weezing.
Weezing, yeah.
So. It's a unique, almost unique typing. It has a pretty unique ability. It has a pretty good move pool. It's just, it's a pretty passive Pokemon. And you have Chiyu. I just feel like it feels like a wasted slot.
Because it's physical is what you're saying.
It actually has a higher physical attack.
It's offensive stats are not high. I see what you're saying.
Yeah. Same thing with Hitmontop. Although Hitmontop is at least Fake Out and Intimidate, which you didn't have before.
Yeah, he's a good C tier pickup for both Intimidate and Fake Out. So like, yeah, I respect that pickup. The
I don't like Zoroark on this team, actually. I think that Zoroark pairs best with a really strong Dark type, and there's just not a Dark type at all.
It does give him a Ghost to do Explosion Aleki with, which is always funny.
That is true. It is quite funny. Especially when you don't know that they're a ghost type. You're not expecting it. But I also don't like Grafaii on this team.
Grafaii is a prankster mon, but I just don't know. What does it do?
Its signature move is called Doodle, which replaces both its ability and its opponent and your partner's with your opponent's ability.
So you like pick an opponent, like you target an opponent, and then you copy that ability to both your mons.
Yes.
Interesting. So if you copy Intimidate, then they got a double minus attack.
Yes.
It's cool.
That's what you normally pair it with. You pair it with like Regigigas or Slinking, and you get rid of their like detrimental ability.
Ah. Okay. So it's like another way of using like Weeze and neutralizing gas or whatever.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Yeah, I could see that being more beneficial with Slaking, because Slaking, the problem is if neutralizing gas gets turned off, then you're just back to being like useless half the time. So like, yeah, this is a little bit better. Then I remember Trey being very upset that Rampardos got picked up. What's the deal with Rampardos? I know it's slow and it's got no defenses. It's just all attack. Like, what does this mon do? Is it just Trick Room shenanigans? Like,
it's not actually. It's kind of slow. It's like high 50s,
70 or something. Okay.
It is a min max Pokemon to the extreme.
It's literally maxed only in one stat, like, and min everything else.
Mm-hmm. I have it in my other draft league.
It's a Trick Room mon, right?
It's Head Smash. I use it for Tailwind.
Oh, okay.
And I just click Rock Slide. And hope I flinch.
I mean, he does have the Slow Bro there, which I have used as my Trick Room mon in a past draft league, and it did very solid. So, I mean, maybe one week he might see a reason to do Trick Room. Obviously, Goodra will do well in that.
Yep, and Hitmontop can as well. Vaporeon can work on the Trick Room.
Mm-hmm.
If it's like a particularly fast team, you can just EV your Pokemon to be like slower instead of Trick Room.
Yeah, it's a lot of his speed,
as an option.
Kinda, yeah, a lot of his speed comes from the Electroweb, really. I mean, I guess he has Tailwind and Serendipity, but it's only 99 base speed, so it's not like the craziest Tailwinder.
Yeah.
So, yeah, I mean, speed control actually could be a slight issue for this team.
Well, it's got Regieleki.
Yeah. Oh, I'm well aware of the Regieleki. Yeah. I flipped out when that thing got drafted, but the and I'm honestly, his team, if it's his team, much better because he has the GU, but.
Mm-hmm. I think this team is pretty good, but I wish there's more ways to abuse CU. Or beats Fruin, please.
Yeah. Well, I mean, if you were to add, so you'd add another like strong special attacker here, is what it sounds like.
Even if it's not like, even if it's in a lower tier, you can find something with like 120 special attack. That's
we have Zoroark right there. I will point out that thing's got 110 base speed and a very high special attack set.
That's true.
But yeah, I mean, he could tag out something from his, you know, one of his maybe the Serendipity. I know you weren't a big fan of that. Maybe he could tag that out for another special attacker or something.
Yeah, it seems very easy to improve and can be very scary.
He's got the parts.
Great. Oh, next up we got you, your team.
Yeah. I love talking about my team, but yeah, I'll let you give your initial impressions, and then I can back in with my thoughts on this, and feel free to be like super critical about it, because I mean, obviously I have tinted lenses, right? So yeah, go ahead.
Well, first of all, fuck you for taking Tinkaton.
you know that's one of my favorite Pokemon.
It's one of my favorite Pokemon too.
And then be faster about it.
No, I actually I needed my C tiers. They're very important for the rain mode. But no, I think this team is pretty strong. My only worry is again with the 4x weaknesses. It's like, especially with Hisuian Arcanine. It's something in my last league where I've had experience, just taking on something like Chilling Water just cripples it so hard. And everything, like not everything, but a lot of Pokemon get Chilling Water in this game. And it's not used because it's a bad move, but in draft, you find moves like that where it's like, oh, a lot of Pokemon just randomly get this weird one-off water move. Might as well do it to have a roll to kill Arcanine. And even if it doesn't, it lowers its attack. Same thing kind of goes for Komo-O and Gastrodon with those 4x weaknesses. Just kind of tech moves onto there. It makes it harder to play around.
Yeah, the Gastrodon, again, I think that might be like the last mon higher tier mon that I drafted. And it honestly just came down to like, well, I guess this is like a good switch in to like support Arcanine, right?
Yeah. Yeah, and it is good for that. I think Gastrodon is still a really good Pokemon on the team. It's just something that on first glance, something that I worry about is 4x weaknesses, and you have 3 of them.
Yeah, and I had 4 of them. So like my draft got, so I'll speak early. So round 3 was the worst round for me because somebody got Sinistee. I don't know who that was. Someone got Sinistee, Porygon 2, and Regieleki right before me. It was my third string like option for that round. All of them got picked like right then, and I was just like, but that changed my entire draft, because after that I pivoted so hard because all my A tiers that I planned on were at that point gone. So like I was like and I started picking up low tier mons after that. So I grabbed my first B tier was the Komo, which we could dive more into that in a bit, and then I grabbed like Tinkaton like round 4, and then I came back and got like A and B like much later, right? But again, one of them that's not up here, I'll talk to that, is the Volcarona I drafted like as like, oh, I guess I'll pick that up. And like I looked at my team after like the draft, I was like, why the fudge are all my A and B tier mons times 4 weaknesses? How did I do that? And I tagged out the Volcarona for Latios like right after I noticed that. Go ahead, pick it back up. I'll have more things to say. But.
I actually really love your low tiers, your D and on tiers. And Electabuzz, I think it's really solid too. And Tinkaton, obviously. I don't love Slowking as much, but that's just a personal preference. And I think it's I think your Trick Room mode is not actually real, and faking it kind of just seems cope. Volbeat is great. It's a really great, really good value. It has Taunt, like Prankster Taunt, Prankster Tailwind. Technically, Encore. You can do. Encore as well. You technically can do Prankster Tail Glow, but that's bad.
I would have to do that on like Latios, which is not the worst.
Yeah.
But it was probably not something you're going to see me do, but I guess it's there.
Yeah, yeah.
The you're picking on Slow King. Let me go ahead and defend him a little bit here. So again, I used Slowbro in the past in a past draft, VGC draft for a Trick Room mod, and it worked really well. The reason I went with Slow King this time around is I lose a little bit of physical bulk, but I get kind of the same shenanigans except for, and I'm not saying I will do it, but I do get the. What's the effing move called that sets up the snow?
Chilling reception into
I get the chilling reception. Into the snow cloak or whatever with Glaceon. So Glaceon now gets more defense. She gets so it can use Blizzard. I have a really copium thing with Glaceon that I noticed is it has a very similar stat line to Raging Bolt. and it's my favorite Eevee. So I was like, oh, and it also has Calm Mind. It's like, if I find the right positioning, like I can really, I really just want to do like a Glaceon sweep, like a Trick Room or something. We'll see if it happens. Obviously I lack like the reliable priority move, right? Because she has like Ice Shard, which is like not special. Mm-hmm. But the there's a little strat I could potentially do there. It might not come to fruition, but that's why I went with Slowkick over Slowbro.
I really like Himmelly. I think it's one of the best untiered mons, I think. I think you got really good value on that one.
It matches up well with Rillaboom, right? Because he has Emberdon.
Yes. It's getting Grassy Seed, I think it's going to be so good. I also really like physical ghost types. It's Poltergeist is an incredible move, and Bayonet has an absurdly high like attack stat for what it looks like. And
that's like its only like good stat, unfortunately. But
yeah, but it does improve your somewhat copium Trick Room mode.
Sure. It's the reason it was drafted outside of being my favorite ghost type is it's also a Slow King can do this too, but obviously being an inherently a ghost makes it a little bit more reliable. Is it's another imprison option for anti Trick Room.
Yeah. And I think Electabuzz is really good. I think it's a really solid mod for...
It is. I'm a Magmar fan myself, but my A tier... The first round I drafted Arcanine, so I was like, well, I probably should pick up Magmar here. And I was like, I don't have Electric type. Obviously, we have the redirection with the Eviolite. You have the Helping Hand. It is somewhat fast with 105 base speed, so against the right team, like you can get like the Electroweb support.
It has at least light screen. I don't know if it has reflect, but it's a decently fast light screener at least. And if
you find yourself in a position where like something has like a times for weakness, he does have like the elemental punches and whatnot too. So, very very solid mod. I actually Kane and I are doing a we need to finish it up. We're doing a Soul Link currently, and Franklin is his name. He's been an all-star. He's one of the long-standing members on the team. We actually coded him. We're right now at the Elite Four, so we did code him into his Electifire form because obviously no way to really evolve him.
Yeah.
Franklin's been an all-star, so glad to have him on my VGC team as well. Let's see, what have I not talked about? The Arcanine was like my round one pick, and it. I definitely dropped the ball on what I told myself I was going to do before this draft started. Because like it got down to me, and it was like there was like four mons that I was like, okay, the ones that are realistically going to be left, these are them. Which one of them technically was Tornadus, but that realistically should not have been left. But Tornadus got down to me, two Urshifus got down to me, and the Rillaboom got down to me.
Did Tornadus just not get picked at all?
It did get picked. It was the very last one to get picked.
Okay.
but yeah, still blows my mind. But the... I told myself though, like I was like, "Hey, if Tornadus comes to me, I just have to pick it up." And like I just didn't do it. I grabbed Arcanine because let Trade do his thing, and then like maybe he would take away an option, give me less choices than I would pick. He didn't even do the Dondozo thing either. But the I picked regular Arcanine because I get the Rock Slide, which I like having a pretty decent fast Rock Slide Pokemon, just for some cheese. Obviously, it's strong. You have the E-Speed. You get Intimidate. But you get those latter things with regular Arcanine, who doesn't have quad weakness. The Rock Slide was really what I wanted there.
And honestly, just the threat of being able to just, hey, fuck it. I'm just going to do click Head Smash. 1 week.
Sure.
I make sure your choice band head smash with Rockhead, and you have to like always prepare for that, which that is what makes History and Arcanine scary. The threat of just the really is so absurdly strong rock move just coming out of nowhere. Which regular Arcanine cannot even come close to matching that.
He does. My thinking was when it came back to me, I made this comment earlier. It's like, I grabbed Rillaboom, right? So it was like, my thinking was, okay, again, outside of Sun, what are the good grass types? And I was like, I already told myself, like, Rillaboom was like one of those S tier ones I would pick up. Like, the grassy terrain is good at dampening, like, some of the ground moves that could hit Arcanine. It gives me terrain control. I get another fake out user. Well, I guess that was my first one at that point. I was like, you know what? I'll grab Rillaboom. I think it's gonna pair well. It's gonna be a good place to start. I think the passive healing is gonna be good for some setup things that I want to do later. That was my thought on the monkey. I guess the only thing we hadn't really talked about, other than the fact that I picked it up, was the Latios. And like, I did not realize how much cool tech the Lottie's had. I mentioned this a bit of when we were talking about Ryan's team, but he has so many cool things. Like, and he's got a couple things that she doesn't have. Like, he has ally swap, which I have not used in forever. I think I've used it on P2 in the past. He doesn't have it anymore. But ally swap is a very cool tech option. A really silly tech option is, and I don't know if I'll ever do it, but it's really funny, is he has access to simple beam. And if I simple beam Komo-O and do Clangorous Soul with Throat Spray, if I get past that turn, I just win the game. It's really funny. Komo obviously has like a deep move pool, which is great for draft. It has two different kinds of setup options. So like, and it's my favorite pseudo legendary. You keep hearing me say favorite. Like I have drafted a lot of like my favorite Pokemon. So I think Komo's gonna be really cool to use.
So something I was going to say was, I thought to myself, why like you got the Komo-O. And you didn't get the Sinistra, you mentioned that. I said, who sniped that from you? And then I realized it was me. I sniped it from you.
Yeah, I was making, yeah, that was my, yeah, my glaringly aggressive comment at the start of this conversation. But the,
I mean, two draft leagues at once, and I just forgot. Like,
that was directed at you. But the, so again, the Komo was definitely something I wanted to pick up, but like the Sinistra was like, okay, that could be very supportive for Komo. It's got redirection, it's got healing. It gives me like a good trick room mon. I was like, yeah, it tends to be a great pickup. Like, obviously, like I kind of backburnered the Sinistea when I went with the Rillaboom, because it gives me two grass types in my higher tiers, like maybe not. But then the Porygon 2 disappeared, and then the Regieleki disappeared, and like I'm like, good lord. Definitely like my speed control like go-tos definitely kind of like faded out, and I had to like kind of adjust. The only other thing I was gonna think of for like Komo was like maybe Clefairy. And the only reason I let it stay there that long, and eventually Ty got it, was like, did I really want to use my A tier pick on like redirection when I probably should pick up something a little more offensive? And that was my train of thought. So like, I picked up the Electabuzz, like, okay, this is a bargain, a solid redirection mon. I can get some more power out of like my A tier pick.
Something I will say, something that I like to do personally, and it kind of reflects in my teams. I like to find really powerful Pokemon in lower tiers that are like crept out, like power crept out for whatever reason. But like something like Revivroom, I don't have it, but like it's a very strong Pokemon. It hits very hard, but it's in down and untiered because its typing is kind of bad, and its speed is not that good. But it hits really hard. So I think being able to find like high power in lower tiers is that, because I think versatility is really what you want from a high tier mon. And I think Latios does a really great job of that. Personally.
Yeah, I think both Lottie and Komo, they have pretty deep move pool. Mm-hmm. And again, Lottie's got the good supportive options as well. So yeah, I think I accomplished part of that goal for sure. Mm-hmm.
I think that not necessarily going just for high power, because something like Indeedee, very good mon in a high tier, not doing any damage on its own, but it supports the team so well and it can do a lot of so many different things. I think it's a good Pokemon to have in A tier. But yeah, I see what you mean though, with because the high powered mons in those top tiers are going to be the highest power. So yep. I think Latios was a great pick.
Yep, and it also gives me another, I guess, ground. Actually, I don't think I had any ground resist up to that point. So, well, I guess Rillaboom, but yeah, immunity, I guess I should say, which is important when I have something like Arcanine running around, right?
So. Along with Tinkaton, which you took pretty early.
Hey, like, relatively. I'll say it a third time, man. She may not be worth a lot, but she's worth a lot to me. So.
Well, no, I'm just saying, like, when you have the Tinkaton as like an earlier pick, it's another ground weakness.
True. Very true.
All right. And last but not least, we got my boy Trey, aka Gliss Special Blend, with the El Paso Eiscue. This is a team that I helped build.
Okay.
So I will be a little bit biased as well, because I think I built a pretty... I think Trey and I built a pretty, like, really good team together.
Yeah. Oh, do you want me to lead the conversation on this one, then?
Yeah, go ahead.
You pretty much built it? Okay, okay. So, you know, Trey kind of spoke to a lot of this when he was doing the draft, too. He definitely wanted to start out with, like, a strong Trick Room option, right? So he grabbed, like, the good setter ups or the supports. Like, he got Iron Hands, which obviously is super strong, too. And he got the Ferrigraph, which, you know, obviously blocks priority, can set up Trick Room. He has, again, the fake out from the Iron Hands. So great supporting mons to make sure Trick Room gets up. I know he wanted the Blood Moon Ursaluna. He still got the regular one. It still hits like a truck. It just doesn't have the Blood Moon move. He got the other Arcanine, so he gets the Intimidate. He gets the E-Speed, which, again, if you're doing a Trick Room team, having priority moves is great on mons that are not necessarily slow. Let's see. Melodic, not a very fast mon, competitive, so if someone else has Intimidate, which against him, great option, right? So, I mean, Arcanine, Ursaluna, Iron Hands, they're all going to be like, okay, I definitely want to Intimidate those mons. But he really makes you really question that, right? Because he has the competitive Melodic, he has the Defiant Bisharp. So, like, you really have to be careful about intimidating his team. And, you know, I think just having those two mons, people might not even bring Intimidate against Trey, which is kind of wild to say with the Ursaluna and Iron Hands, but possible.
Yeah.
I'll pause there, because, I mean, I can start digging into some of the other ones here, but I think I've hit the core of what you're going for, right?
Yeah, so that was pretty... you got the idea. Generally, we did want the Blood Moon, but Blood Moon got taken, and, I mean, regular one's still really good. Also, notably... usually want to do Guts with Flame Orb, because that just it makes it hit so absurdly hard. However, it also has an ability called Bulletproof, which is a really weird ability. All, like, Ball and Sphere and Bullet moves, except for Bullet Seed. Mm-hmm. That still hits. But, like...
That's weird.
Yeah.
I guess that's a translational error, though.
Yeah, it is.
Kind of like Sucker Punch is not a punching move.
Mm-hmm. But yeah, like, it's a weird one where it's like, if you see that your opponent has like quite a few of those, like Energy Ball or a Sphere or something like that, you can just tech that on and people won't see it coming and you're just immune. Just straight up immune, which is really neat. So we want to do the Trick Room. As of, if you want to, like, have a hard Trick Room team, or even just have a really, like, strong, like, the most solid Trick Room mode, take Ferrigraph. And, That's what happened, and yes, basically just saying I'm the only one that can use priority is so nice. There are so many. Oftentimes people's the way to stop Trick Room is like priority taunt with like Prankster or something, and can't do that. So being able
you have to imprison this team, right?
Pretty much, yeah.
Pretty much. Yeah.
And if you are imprisoning, it means you're spending a turn not attacking. And that's also scary, because if you get it wrong, and it just, like, Iron Hands just goes Sword Stance, and then Ferrigraph just goes, like, Hyper Voice with Throat Spray. Oh no. What do I do now? You know? So I think... Yeah.
I think imprison's pretty... like, if the mon's on the field, it's very obvious they're going to try to imprison you, too. So, like, you can kind of work around it.
Yep. Trey also took Illumise from me, which I was very sad
about.
Yeah,
that was a bit of a betrayal. but obviously, one of the lower tiered prankster mons for Tailwind, right?
So I literally said, hey, I think I'm going to take Illumise as my next pick. And he says, ooh, wait, what? Illumise? That actually seems really good. I think I'm going to take that.
Wait, that happened live?
Yes, this was in real life.
Oh,
I was like,
that
was
theme.
I know. I was betrayed by my friend, but it's okay. I think
you can't spell betray without Trey.
But yeah, generally, but yeah, with Milo and Bisharp, which Bisharp I think was a criminally underrated mod as well.
Yeah, I agree. This mod used to be a very staple pick in a lot of VGC mm-hmm. formats, right?
Yeah.
So.
Yes, Milo, and it's basically deterring Intimidate as much as possible, because we have mm-hmm. those top three that are pretty weak to Intimidate. But if you say, hey, you can kind of cripple my team. And I think, honestly, Intimidate is still good enough into the team that people will still bring it. And that's good. That's good for the team, because you get Milo to plus two. Suddenly, Scald is actually, doing chip and spraying burn. It's like, oh, this is a real option to pick up KOs.
It's doing damage.
Mm-hmm. And then the only thing is, I guess, didn't touch on the lower tiers. Masquerain is he just likes Masquerain.
It's an Intimidate mod. He didn't have one, so
he has an Arcanine. But
oh yeah, you're right. Never mind. I don't know what I'm talking about. I mean, if you like, I respect drafting a Pokemon you like. So you know what. Good for
and
him.
Then Diplin is one of the trick room option.
What does it do? Tell me what it does.
So it has a move called it's not actually that trick room. It can be. Anyways, it's very slow. Its ability is whenever it enters the battle, it lowers the evasion of your opponents by one stage.
Oh, okay. I thought that was a high Drapple thing. Okay, so they both have it.
Yeah. And so that was the combo with Toxicroak. Toxicroak kind of it's only okay. However, because it doesn't hit that hard with poison and jab, but if you have gunk shot, it actually starts to it's like, oh, this is real damage. But then you have to run gunk shot. But with these, I forget what the ability is called. But with the ability, your gunk shots always hit.
Well, okay. So now here's a good question: is the with one evasion stat drop? Like what does that do to the percentage of moves? Right. So he's got a couple of sing options here as well. Like what the sing's normally 55%. So like after an invasion drop, what is that looking like now?
I do not know.
Okay. All right. Probably something more relevant for Hypnosis, which is like what, 60, 65 or something? But the
I will say that the one Pokemon that I did not help with or pick in any custody was Altaria, and it also happens to be my least favorite part of the team. I just don't know what it does.
That's why, again, I was thinking Sing with the evasion drop maybe, but the I mean, when you look at the untiers, I mean, some people probably just drafted some favorites. I think that's a that's definitely like a I would say what a niche favorite. I don't think there's a lot of Altaria fans out there, but
yeah.
Let's see. I mean, what? He doesn't have any other dragon. Is that his only dragon? I guess it is.
No, it's Diplin.
Oh, Diplin. Okay. I was like, the dragon cheer? Like, probably not in Diplin, though. I guess it's a Hazemon.
Anyway, it might just be he likes it pick.
Yeah.
So.
I think that's very likely. I mean, there you see the mask screen, so it is. The his other C tier, which is the only thing I think we have not really touched on, is our our mycelian mite friend over here, which I immediately started thinking about what you told me about Grofy Eye. Like, well, can you turn off that mycelian mite and have a base 100 speed special?
You cannot.
But it doesn't even turn off.
It's one of those abilities that cannot be replaced.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So the only thing you can do is neutralize and gas that ability.
Yes.
Okay. Well, that's not an option here. So I'm not. I mean, did he have. He's got. Again, I'm about to say, does he have any grass types? I was like, oh yeah, yet again, Diplin is the answer to my question. So,
no. The Switchblow is our secondary Trick Room setter.
Oh, I didn't know I got Trick Room.
It does, indeed. So currently, it's kind of a hard Trick Room team. Not entirely hard, but pretty heavily Trick Room team with only one setter. But this gives it a secondary setter, which also does not share any types with the primary setter.
Well, and another thing I'm realizing is that this is his only redirection mod, right?
Mm-hmm.
So that's a nice option to have. Okay, I'm picking up what y'all are putting down.
Yep.
Let me see. Does he have any common? Like, I mean, ice is obviously the big problem for him. Which I guess the only shared weakness is the Ursaluna and the Altaria.
And
Altaria is kind of like whatever. But
well, and Toadscruel, and Diplin.
No. That's what I'm saying. I'm saying Toad. Oh, Diplin. Okay. Realistically,
this team is pretty weak.
Let's take a step back. Though. Realistically speaking, mm-hmm. on a team that is going to be brought that week. Probably not going to have Diplin and Toadscruel on the same team.
That's
so, like,
true.
In terms of sharing an ice weakness, really just the bear, right?
Right. But
that in mind, the opponent probably should bring ice moves against this team if they can.
That's what I was saying about the opportunity cost before. If you have a lot of Pokemon weak to ice, you know you can just bring Ice Beam on them on, and it'll hit most of the team. You don't have to, like, prep it for any one Pokemon.
Yep.
But yes, this team is ice weak, but that's why we have the, Milo and Bisharp again, and Arcanine, as those like heavily punish ice. I guess Arcanine especially heavily punishes, as well as Bisharp, and Milo just resists it. But
Well, and I'm not saying people are gonna bring ice types specifically.
You're
right. But I mean, whatever. Mm-hmm. He's already brittle. But,
yeah.
I don't think it's gonna. I don't think it's a big Achilles heel.
Even if the team doesn't have, like, a lot of, like, good ice moves, it means they would have to go Terra Ice, like Terra Blast. And that's punishes that in particular.
That's true. I forgot what generation we were talking about here. Right?
Fair. But yes, that's trade's team, and I think that'll wrap us up.
It does. I think it's going to be a very fun season. We're already... most of the way through week one. A lot of games still left to be played, so probably a lot of action tomorrow. But definitely looking forward to this season. Looking forward to using my team, of course, and looking forward to seeing what everybody else does. Puts on a good show. And
Hopefully we'll see you in finals again next season, or this season.
It sounds like, you know, it's always up in the air for me, man. I definitely sounds like a plan, but... Man, I don't typically play Pokemon anymore outside of these draft leagues. So, like, I always have to, like, relearn things. So, I'm always scared I'm more scared at the beginning of a draft league than the end because, like, I'm having to relearn things. But, yeah, I'll figure it out. I'll figure it out for sure. I'm looking forward to another good match for us.
All right, well, see you later, gamers.